Stadium, NBC World Series. It's the 81st edition of this tournament. And the Santa Barbara Foresters this year are looking to win their sixth title, which would be the most of any franchise that has ever won a championship at the NBC World Series. The Mustangs looking for their first, but again, they're making their fifth appearance in their 7 years of existence. So Santa Barbara's had a few more chances since they've been around since 1956. They are back here in the NBC World Series. Now 24 consecutive seasons since 1992. They're back this year here in 2015. Let's meet these starters in our game today. First for the Foresters, who come in 36-7. Bill Pintard is their manager. He's been their manager for a long, long time. And they expect him to probably retire here fairly shortly, but he loves the NBC World Series, and he has brought his team back. He'll go like this. Leading things off is a shortstop, John Holland. Hitting second is Matt Henderson, and he will play third base. Ranger Studdard will hit third, and he'll play first base today. The catcher is Jeremy Montalbano, as he will clean things up. Tyler Neslani is the left fielder, and he will hit fifth. David Greer hits sixth, and he will be the DH today. Michael Smith will hit seventh, and he will play in right field. John Bronsema is the second baseman, and he will hit number eight. And Ryan Chandler is the center fielder, and he will hit ninth for the Santa Barbara Foresters. Glenn Otto again on the mound from Rice University, as he will throw it today. Big right-hander, 6'4", 225-pounder, but he will try and shut down the Mustangs today. They've had quite a few guys warming up, probably some guys just on some side sessions, getting ready for innings later on in the tournament. Glenn Otto will be scheduled to turn today for the Santa Barbara Foresters. For the St. Joseph Mustangs, they'll go the exact same way that they did yesterday.
Fans talking about the 81st in NBC World Series.
Right now, the 26th
on the Cole Kirk baseball around the clock.
Players, though, they don't have a ton of backups, so I'm sure we'll probably see this for the most part the rest of the season and the rest of the season.
Day three of baseball around the clock and game one of our evening session here at Boston Stadium.
For the most part, this is what they've got, along with about 11 or 12 arms in
our 4 o'clock game, which is now scheduled for 5:30.
Leading things off, playing in left field.
Jacob Richardson visiting St. Joe, Missouri Mustangs.
Trent Hill will hit number 3.
And the home team in right. Santa Barbara, California.
Scott will clean things up. And he plays first base. The DH is Josh Cassidy.
The starting lineups. First for the visiting Mustangs from St. Joe, Missouri.
Frankie Allen left field number 24. He will hit number 7.
Orencio Fisher. So,
hitting 8th is Jerry Houston.
And second, center fielder number 4, Jacob Richardson.
And Jackson Schnurbush will play shortstop.
And third, the right fielder number 24, Trent Hill.
And again, we've talked a lot about the Foresters pitching
clean
staff.
Up first base and number 32, Ramsey
Scott. Today's starter for the Mustangs has been fantastic all year long.
And fifth, the designated hitter, number 17, John
he
Cassidy.
He received the victory in the Mink League Championship
game. And sixth, third baseman, number 34, Tony Maselli.
Through 6 innings, and again, didn't have his best stuff, but
still seventh,
through the opposite.
Catcher, number 20, Francisco Alvarez.
7-1 at one point, but he still picked up.
And eighth, second baseman, number 14, Jerry Houston.
This season, Dixon is 5-1.
At a ninth shortstop, number 3,
Jackson innings. He's only got 44 hits in 53 innings. He struck out
the pitcher for the Mustangs.
Well, this group is at 1.06, as he is ahead 0-1 of most bats.
Head coach for the Mustangs is Matt Johnson, and he's assisted by Johnny Coy, Blake McFadden,
St. Joseph Mustangs against the defending national champion Santa Barbara Foresters right here on 6-8.
The starting lineup for today's home team.
We continue from Wichita, Kansas. It's the NBC World Series as it continues. It's day number 3 of championship weekend. And we start to get, this is a big game for these two teams because the winner of this game will get tomorrow off and be off until, well, probably either the 6 or 9 game on Tuesday night. So they would have tomorrow off and then be off most of the day on Tuesday until they would play Tuesday night. So again, a big game for both teams. We'll see what happens today. As the St. Joseph Mustangs try to knock off in the team that most people want to be right now. The Santa Barbara Foresters, a team that has won 3 of the last 4 championships here at the NBC World Series. And Bill Pintard puts together a very good baseball team every single year. The all Division I guys, you've got Rice, Mississippi State, Texas Tech, Texas State.
Looking to beat the
UC San Diego
for the perfect corporate entertainment. Reserve your climate control skybox today and watch San Diego World Series like never before. While you and your guests
turn on bus or kill again, he said, yeah, they're
NBCBaseball.com.
Their team is entire Division I guys,
availability
last. Dallas players, but We got a lot of D1 guys as well.
Park City Convention and Tourism Committee welcomes all the players and fans to the NBC World Series. For information about food and lodging in Park City, visit parkcityks.com. Park City is also the proud sponsor of the NBC World Series pitch clock out in right field.
The Forsters won their first game 9-3.
Hey fans, make sure to check out the official NBC World Series gift shop. We have NBC hats and shirts, mini hats, and more.
Scores in baseball.
Your favorite college in our Z hats display. And don't miss out on your chance to get a great souvenir at the NBC gift shop.
And the Monarchs came back to beat the San Antonio Titans.
Upgrade your television by entering for a chance to win a brand new 4K LG TV from Hefner TV Electronics. You can win this TV value of over $900 when purchasing your NBC World Series program different and filling out your raffle slip. Each program earns you one contest entry.
That game went long before us as Hutchinson stays alive.
Wake up on the bright side at La Quinta Indian Suites Airport, located off the West Kellogg and Dugan Road exit. All rooms receive a complimentary hot buffet breakfast in the morning.
They are beat the Colts at a Colorado, beat Finland Valley. California Pirates 4-2 today.
Morning and meeting the Bengals in
Illinois lost to a Lake Erie Michigan.
Traveling soon.
Lake Erie if the Mustangs part of the loser of this game, whoever loses, but if the Mustangs would have to lose this game, then they drop down to the loser's bracket and they would play the Lake Erie Monarchs who won earlier today.
Are you the ultimate NBC World Series fan?
The Mustangs will lose this game. So
today, show your fandom.
Great Monarchs.
NBC fan club members receive an exclusive fan club t-shirt, Conkers, free tickets, premium access to VIP NBC events, and much more. Ask an NBC staff member
all over the country.
Special member of baseball history today.
81st edition of the NBC World Series. We get one more break and come back in the first.
If you love baseball,
St. Joseph Mustangs
and barbecue, come out to the stadium early Saturday, August 8th. Second annual All Saints Barbecue and NBC Championship Cookoff. Enjoy mouth-watering barbecue and vintage baseball with Wichita Bullfighters and Topeka Westerns. Cap your night off with the NBC World Series Championship.
It's the Mustangs and Foresters. This is St. Joseph Mustangs baseball.
Hutchinson Monarch staff members walking through the crowd.
They're back in Wichita.
They'll be taking donations.
The St. Joseph Mustangs taking on the Santa Barbara
BJ's Batter Boy, Kaiser Carlisle.
If you'd like to contribute. The NBC World Series. They got a fair line. Center, he hits second.
Trent Hill for Santa Barbara.
He'll play right
34 is Len Otto.
Things up at first. Josh Caskey's the DH in the 5-hole. Hitting six is Tony Maselli at third base.
Leading off of the St. Joe, Missouri Mustangs. Left fielder number 44, Arencio Fisher.
Hit eight and plays second base. And hitting ninth is Jackson Sherbush, and he'll be the shortstop for the St. Joseph Mustangs. As we are set for baseball, we're in round two of the NBC World Series. Glenn Otto, the pitcher, and Arencio Fisher from Missouri Western will lead things off. He swings the first pitch and fouls it off to the right side as our first pitch comes at 5:32. Currently 91 degrees here in Wichita. Our time at temp brought to you by Rock Ridge Steel Company. Visit them online at rockridgesteelcompany.com. Here's the 0-1 pitch to Arencio Fisher. Good off-speed that time, and he swings and just foul tips it. And it will be no balls and two strikes. At Rock Ridge Steel, we've customized your metal needs like no other company and create quality and precise metalwork at competitive rates. Again, online, rockridgesteelcompany.com. O is down 0-2 as Arencio on the season hitting 281. He swings and misses here, and just like that, a three-pitch strikeout for Glenn Otto, who, again, in 40
digital office system, Wichita sales and service provider, the office printers, copy and IT solutions,
and
strikeout on your
only
office technology,
base
today to solve your business challenges with unique customized solutions to improve your game.
38 and a third.
Center fielder number 4, Jacob Richards,
is allowed, and 51 strikeouts. First pitch he throws is high and has very good velocity. We've seen some of the off-speed stuff with movement to the right-handers already against Arencio Fisher. First pitch is high, and now time was called. So he still threw
no pitch
into the backstop, no pitch. It's a one ball and no strike count to Jacob Richardson. Jacob went 1-for-3 with two RBIs, had a big two RBI base hit with two outs in the fourth inning of that three-run fourth, making a 6-1 game of the time against Hutchinson. Mustangs. Center fielder swings and misses a high fastball this time. He's got a 1-1 count. On the season, the sophomore, who just wrapped up his sophomore year at Hart Community College, he's a Goddard, Kansas native, just about 5 minutes from here, where we're at in downtown Wichita. Maybe a little bit stronger. Pitch high, now it's two balls, no strike. But he is hitting 294 this season, a homer and 24 driven in now. He bats right-handed against Glenn Otto. Here's Otto's pitch, one inside, three balls, no strike. He's only walked 12 this summer, but he did walk at Rice 28 batters in 41 innings, so a little bit higher during his school ball as compared to what he's done this summer for the Foresters. Here's the 3-1 pitch. Richardson broke his bat, I think. It's a shallow left center field, and it will get down for a base hit. High hop, and it's handled by Neslani on left field, but he broke his bat, I believe. And he'll loop one in the left field for a base hit. On a 3-1 fastball, got jammed but fouled off, and he got it in play.
Strikeout number 24, Trent Hill.
So a single for Jacob Richardson, and he is on first base with one down. The catcher, Jeremy Montalbano, who was on the team a year ago and then won the championship, was checking the bat, giving it back to Trent Hill, and he's telling him, I think it's got a crack in it. Richardson off of first base. It'd be tough to steal on the Foresters. Again, obviously Otto throws hard, which that certainly will help the catcher, but then Montalbano, who played 2 years at Texas, and now he's transferred to Tulane, had to sit out this past season. He's a very, very good catcher behind the plate. A couple of throws over first base. Richardson does have 18 steals and 23 attempts this season. He's off of first base as Trent Hill, who went 4-for-5 in yesterday's game, digs in. He looks at the first pitch high for ball one. In 2 years, going back to last year and this year for Trent Hill, he is now 9 out of 15 hitting in this state. At the NBC World Series, he's 9-for-15. His average now on the season, as he put a first base not in time, his average now is grown to 348, no homers. He drove in one yesterday, has 22 RBI. He almost went 5-for-5. He missed a home run by about 2 feet down the left field line. He went the opposite way and ended up striking out looking. Ground ball towards short, could be two. They turn one at second, the relay is in time. A 6-4-3 double play, and the Foresters erase that one out single by Jacob Richardson. After a half inning, it's St. Joseph Mustangs nothing. The Santa Barbara Foresters coming up from the NBC World Series here in Wichita on 680 KFEQ. We continue from Wichita, Kansas at Lawrence Dumont Stadium. The banks of the Arkansas River. And Dave Ritter, thanks for joining me for Mustangs baseball in the 81st edition of this tournament. And the Mustangs in the second round. They won their opening game, all 5 appearances here at the NBC. All time, they're now 11-8 at the NBC World Series. We'll see if they can knock out one of the big boys of this tournament. The Santa Barbara Foresters, and they come to play for the first time. Mustangs, and a one-out single from Jacob Richardson, but he was retired after the double play ball by Trent Hill.
Leading off for the Santa Barbara, California Foresters.
And for Santa Barbara,
it'll
be John
Holland.
He is the shortstop that began that 6-4-3 double play. He leads off hitting left-handed. And Marble on the mound for the Mustangs. He is 5-1 so far this year. Here's a ball hit to right center field, but Trent Hill played it perfectly. He'll make the catch on the run into right center field. That will be one pitch, one out.
Baseman number 9, Matt Henderson.
Fly ball out to Trent Hill, who hasn't played a ton of outfield. He's played his share, though. He's played some in right, a little bit in left also this year, but again, without Kyle Richards now, they also don't have Scott Brerin with them as Richards playing for the Kansas City T-Bones, and Brerin had to go back home for some other responsibilities. First pitch from Dixon is low for ball one to Matt Henderson. Trent Hill, likely going to be a fixture in right. We could see some Jordan Powell out there as well. Here's the 1-0 pitch from Marble, and it'll be outside. Two balls and no strikes to Matt Henderson. Henderson, the third baseman, plays at Santa Barbara Community College. And they tell me he has signed to play at Florida State, so he will be a Seminole after 2 years at Santa Barbara Community College. There's a ball strike in her hat. On the season, Henderson is hitting 338, no homers and 11 RBIs. He hit 329 for Santa Barbara Community College this past season. He's from Somas, California. Now an off-speed pitch that he's way out in front of it. Now it's a 2-ball-and-2-strike count. Henderson has come back to even up the count at 2. On deck is Granger Studdard. He plays at Texas State. No score here in the first. Dixon's 2-2 pitch. Hit down the right field line, twisting, and it will be a fair ball. He gets all the way to the wall. He's going to press the bases. Trent Hill bobbles it for a second, and now he's going to try for 3. The relay, a stick in the glove of Jackson Schnurba,
launch a triple down the right field line. Matt Henderson, the third baseman, went 2-for-5 in yesterday's game with a double, has his second extra base hit this tournament. He is a third baseman.
First baseman number 7, Granger, right stuttered.
Probably would have just been a double had Trent Hill picked it perfectly up off of the turf, but unfortunately he was not able to. LaForster's a runner at third base, and just one out. That brings up Granger, stutter the first baseman. He swings it left-handed as well. First pitch is outside for ball one from Jason Marble. Stutter plays at Texas State. He has power, 4 homers, and he leads the Foresters with 39 RBI this season. And he's got a runner at third base with one down. They obviously play back this early in the game. High and away, 2 balls and no strikes. Coach Johnson talked earlier today that he just wanna stay ahead of these guys, make them put the ball in play, get ahead 0-1, but he's been behind 2-0 to the last 2 batters. Blue off speed again, out in front of it, swings and misses. Throwing some change-ups here early on, both to Henderson and now to Stutter, but Henderson able to adjust and hit a triple down the right field line. 2 balls and a strike to Stutter. 331 average, get 281 with 11 homers at Texas State this past year. Curveball stays high away. Green won the count now. Danger of putting a man on base. That's shooting at first and third with one out. 3 balls and a strike. From Dixon Marble to Granger, Stutter takes a deep breath. The pitch home. Called strike, outside corner. Shane sort of walk down to first base. It's a called strike, now it's full. Jeremy Montalbano is on deck, the catcher. He has 7 homers, 35 RBI this season. Here's the pitch from Marble. Off speed, foul back. It stays 3 balls and 2 strikes. Dixon pitched in last year's tournament. He received a no decision in the game that he threw in the last game against the Valley Center Diamond Dogs, which they lost 8-5. He lasted just 4 1/3 innings. Ground ball right, so the infield's going to score a run. Jerry Houston will have it. Goes to first base, but the Santa Barbara Foresters take a 1-0 lead.
Looking for equipment ground to take your game to the next level? How about performance apparel and uniforms for practice and game day? Visit baseballsavings.com for the best selection and lowest prices.
Doesn't really mean a lot, but when the opposition scores first, the Mustangs, this year 6-13, when they score first, they're 30-2. And the pop-up on the infield from Montalbano. Francisco Alvarez calls everybody off to make the catch right down the first base line, and that will retire the Foresters. But they get one run on one hit, no errors, and nobody left on base. With one complete, Santa Barbara 1 and St. Joseph nothing right here on 680 KFEQ. First pitch was up and in here to start the second to Ramsey Scott. 4, 5, and 6, middle third for the St. Joseph Mustangs. Well, now throws a fastball for a strike on the outer half. 1-1. As the St. Joseph Mustangs again taking on the Santa Barbara Foresters. The Mustangs 0-2 all time against the Foresters. Now it's a 2-1 count on a breaking pitch in the turf, I guess I should say, here at Lawrence Dumont Stadium. All turf, it's a very quick surface. But obviously, I see a lot of games in Missouri Western, and that plays more like grass. It doesn't seem like there's so many infield hits, but here, the ball swoops through the infield, and boy, if you hit it, it gets chopped up in the air, and you've got a good chance to get a base hit. 3 balls on a strike, fastball high that time. Ramsey Scott ahead in the count. Let's see if he can take advantage of it. 3 balls and 1 strike to Ramsey Scott, the 4-hole hitter. There's a called strike outside. On the season, Ramsey's hitting .291. He leads the Mustangs with 5 home runs and also leads them with 35 RBI. He is signed to play at Murray State after 2 years at Maple Woods Community College. It's a 3-2 from Glenn Otto and a ground ball to second base. Jammed him that time. With the ball is Ron Zima and he'll throw him out. So a 4-3 ground out on a 3-2 pitch that he got jammed on.
The designated hitter number 17, John Cassidy.
We'll bring up Josh Cassidy, who got the scoring start for the Mustangs in the first inning yesterday with a 2-out RBI single to center field. Made it 1-0, and then Tony Maselli, who was on deck, hit that 2 RBI double with 2 down. Make it a 3-0 score in the top of the first inning. Cassie finished the day yesterday 1-for-4. He's 3-for-9 all the time. Now sends one to right center field. It's going to find the gap. Josh Cassie will round first base. And for second, and he will make a long turn that's standing right there at second base. A double for Josh Cassie. With one out, Mustangs have been in scoring position. The time run now at second base for one down. It's Josh Cassie. It's his fourth hit and 10 ABs lifetime at the NBC World Series. And the Mustangs jump in on the first pitch a lot. It's around where they like it, around the strike zone. They are going to be aggressive. Matt Johnson said, you've got to against power pitchers. They're going to throw some power stuff, some fastballs on the first pitch of each at-bat. Try and jump on it if you can. Now Maselli, he doubled the center field in the first inning last game. It's an off-speed pitch for a strike this time. Mustangs down 1-0 here in the top of the second. Called strike to Maselli, who on the season is hitting 239, went 2-for-5 with those two RBIs yesterday. He had a double and struck out one time. Hasn't got a ton of playing time here late in the year, but took advantage of it yesterday, and he'll get a lot of playing time throughout this entire week as long as the Mustangs are alive in this tournament. Here's the pitch. Slaps it down the left field line, foul line of play. So an off-speed pitch to Maselli. Sends into the stands
of left field Monarchs. Now walking through the stands, taking donations for the liberal BJ
Boston College.
Kaiser Carlisle.
East Coast flavor from Division I on this roster. The
fourth have the attention of these South staff members and West Monarchs.
Paper on their roster. 1-0 our score. 0-2 count to Maselli with Cassie at second base and one down in the second. Auto check second real quick. Now the delivery home. In the dirt, gets away. And that will allow Cassie to get to third base. He's going to round third and stay right there as the ball went kind of in the no man's land. There's a little corner that it went into. And Montalbano had to go chase it down. And now the Mustangs have a runner at third base with less than two outs. So a chance here to tie up the game on a ground ball. They'll play back as well, just like the Mustangs did. See if Maselli can do what Granger Stutter did and just get the ball to one of the middle infielders and get a run home. So a wild pitch that time allows Cassie to get to third base. See if he can just get the bat on the ball right now. 1-2 the count with one out. The pitch, Maselli tries to check his swing. They appeal and they're going to say he went around. And Maselli did not hesitate. He for the takeoff toward the dugout.
Catcher number
they even checked.
Francisco Alvarez.
He could not hold up on a high fastball. He strikes out. Big strikeout for Glenn Otto as he could not get the ball in play. Now it's up to Frankie Alvarez with two down and Cassie at third base. Mustangs down 1-0. Francisco went 1-for-5 in yesterday's game. He's 2-for-9 lifetime and two World Series appearances. He's had a rough season. Looks at a fastball right down the middle. That was probably a pretty good pitch to jump on right there. Alvarez hitting just 210 this summer. Two home runs, 12 RBI after a great year at Garden City Community College. He signed to play at Arkansas State. The pitch, high speed, blown away. Like a slider. That time from Glenn Otto, the sophomore to be at Rice University in Houston. Alvarez bats right-handed. The Mustang backstop. And tie this game up with a two-out base hit. Here's the pitch. Fastball high and away. Alvarez this past year hit 371, 11 homers, 38 RBI, 62 runs scored as he was named the Garden City Community College Athlete of the Year among all their sports and also was named the Jayhawk West MVP in that league. 2-1 pitch. Got the corner. Two balls and two strikes. He didn't necessarily agree with that call, but now it's a 2-2 count with two down and a runner at third base. Josh Cassie, a one-out double. Advanced on the wild pitch. Maselli struck out. Now it's up to Francisco Alvarez. Otto from the stretch. 2-2. Hit in the air to left field. It's hit pretty well. Going in and now going back is Nislani. Misplays it. It's going to bounce over the fence. A ground rule double for Francisco Alvarez. as Neslani misplayed the ball in left field, and the St. Joseph Mustangs have tied things up.
ABC
top of inning number two against the Santa Barbara Fieldsters. A big drop base hit for the Staple Neslani in left field. And the games that I've seen, I'll be honest, there have been some badly misplayed balls. The game before us, there were a couple. Trent Hill misplayed one for the Mustangs yesterday. Two Hutchinson players misplayed balls in the air, so just what looked like a routine fly ball was misplayed by Neslani, and a double, as it never did touch his glove, and the Mustangs have tied the game. Now Jerry Houston with a base hit might be able to give the Mustangs a lead. St. Joseph with three hits already off of Glenn Otto. First pitch is high. Again, he's only allowed 20 hits. Dude, that was at Rice. He allowed 20 hits and 41 innings at Rice. But still, so far this summer, as he delivers the 1-0 pitch, it's fouled away to the off the right side. This summer, Otto's only allowed 23 hits and 38 and a third with the game.
Check out ImpactWorks.com.
The Mustangs having some success here early on.
Along with football.
Now, they did get some help as Neslani again misplayed that in left field. And then it bounced up over the fence. Although that thing took off a little farther than I thought it was going to, because he kind of lunged at that baseball. Frankie, a big RBI here with a two-out double. He's at second base and a 1-1 count to Jerry Houston. He lifted a fastball high. So Houston ahead in the count, two balls and a strike. In yesterday's game had an infield base hit. As Jerry finished 1-for-4, he was also hit by a pitch, hitting 274. A redshirt sophomore to be at Missouri. Transferring from the University of Oregon. Had to sit out due to the NCAA transfer rule at Mizzou this past season. Fastball high again. Three balls and a strike to Houston with Jackson Schnurbush on deck. Now he's up to 20 pitches this inning. He could have got out of this with about 13 or 14. Now he's up to 20. He's thrown 30 now through an inning and two-thirds. Three balls and a strike to Houston. Jerry the Mustang's second baseman. Swings it right-handed. Otto comes set. Next second one time. Alvarez takes a step back and a walk. He threw it inside to him. So Otto having a hard time against the Mustangs. The bottom part of the order.
Villages and
now
that he's
Jackson Schnurbush with a chance. Two down and two on. Mustangs and Santa Barbara tied up one here in the
second inning. Enjoy engaging socials, enriching spiritual opportunities.
21 pitches now in his prayer. He's still got a win with Jackson Schnurbush from yesterday.
Visit theChristyVillages.org for more information.
They changed one of his at-bats after the game as well. He was 0-for-4 during the game, but they gave him an infield hit as opposed to an error.
Shortstop number three, Jackson Schnurbush.
He finished the game yesterday 1-for-4, 2-run score, as he did walk one time in the game as well. Jackson hitting 228, no homers and 22 RBI. He swings it right-handed. Here's the pitch. First pitch off speed is right in there for strike one. Otto's been a little wild with his fastball, but he went off speed the first pitch to Jackson Schnurbush. No balls and a strike to the Mustang shortstop. 1-1 our score here in the top of the second. Otto takes a deep breath. He looks at second base one more time. Frankie not a very big lead. In the dirt, gets away, and Frankie will try and get down to third base. The throw is not in time. Francisco Alvarez advances, as does Jerry Houston. It's a 1-1 count now with that ball in the dirt. Another wild pitch thrown by Otto. And a base hit here could give the Mustangs a 3-run inning. Let's see if they can take advantage of it with Jackson Schnurbush in that 9-hole and a 1-1 count. Tried some breaking pitches that have went about 58 feet. Houston at second, Alvarez at third base. A good read by Frankie, didn't get too far away from Montalbano, the catcher. Here's the 1-1. Jackson looks at the pitch high. Two balls in a strike. Laurencio Fisher is on deck, the Mustang leadoff man. One run in the inning on two base hits. Tied the game at one here in the second. Otto, a long look into Montalbano. Gets the sign from the two-lane green wave catcher. A 2-1 pitch. Fastball, called strike the letters. A little bit up in the zone, but it was a called strike. Jackson, the gassy umpire. No question. Otto has said yes. Now it's a 2-ball and 2-strike count. Jackson Schnurbush, a chance to give the Mustangs a lead here in the second.
Renato comes set from the stretch. The pitch and the dirt. It's now full, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Again, the top of the order is on deck. They've all seen Otto one time now. Three balls and two strikes are in the top of the second. Otto's now thrown 26 pitches in this inning. He comes set again from the stretch. Scherbush wiggles his bat. The payoff pitch, swing and miss. Fastball up, and he struck him out as the Mustangs lead two. But they get one on two hits, and we're tied at one after an inning and a half here in Wichita. With Santa Barbara and St. Joseph here on 680 KFET. First pitcher in the bottom of the second from Dixon Marble. High away for ball one to Tyler Mislani, who misplayed that ball in left field for the Foresters. And the Mustangs a double for Francisco Alvarez in a tie baseball game here in the second inning. We are tied at one, ground ball up the middle, right to the wickets of Dixon Marble, and it'll be through for a base hit. So Mislani, who was 1 for 5 in yesterday's game, hitting 370 on the season. He's a Red Raider from Texas.
Does he need a hitter number 22, David Greer.
At base hit. Now single now. That'll bring up David Greer, the DH. Greer is the only change in the lineup for Santa Barbara. He did not play in yesterday's game. The DH was Troy Conyers. He went 0-for-3. Now there goes the runner. Francisco's throw is high. Gets into the outfield. And it will be a stolen base. Backing up the play was Jacob Richardson. But they ran on the first pitch. And a stolen base from Neslani. He now has 4 steals and 5 attempts. He has not tried very many. He had just 2 steals at Texas Tech this past year. He was a starter for the Red Raiders. The first pitch, I believe, was high for ball one. And this line gets the stolen base. There's a called strike on the outside corner. David Greer, he plays at Arizona State. This past year, hit 314 for the Sun Devils with 2 homers and 28 RBI. 1-1 our score, and good curveball that time, swings and misses. 1 ball, 2 strikes the count. Let's see if we can get it out here and keep the runner at second base. Lead off single by Neslani. Dixon Marble comes set. He looks back at second. Neslani stays put, pitches a fastball outside. 2 balls and 2 strikes. David Greer, the DH, 6'190-pound right-hander from Scottsdale, Arizona. Did strikeout 42 times at Arizona State this past season. He's hitting 394, though, for Santa Barbara this summer with a homer, 21 RBIs. He's only struck out 11 times and walked 19 times. A much better summer than what he had at Arizona State. He still played well there. 2 balls and 2 strikes, off speed. He's able to check his swing. He thought about going around, did not. So now it's full, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Marble threw just 14 pitches in that first inning. He gave up the 1 run, though. 3 balls and 2 strikes to David Greer. Again, he's the DH in today's game. Runner at second, nobody down. Marble's pitch, ground ball right side of the infield, gonna get thrown to the third base. Jerry Houston's got it, throws him out at first base. For a 4-3 ground out, but a very productive out for Greer to get the runner to the third base with less than 2 hits.
Right fielder number 3, Michael Smith.
Now runner at third base with 1 down for the second consecutive inning. It'll be hard to win this game if that continues. Now Michael Smith will dig in, the right fielder. He plays at Mississippi State, Franklin, Tennessee, and on to the Bulldogs in the SEC. Mississippi State, they're just a couple of years removed from having an outstanding team that made the College World Series, but this past year, they were only 24-30, and they went 8-22 in the SEC, so a huge drop the last couple of years from Mississippi State. First pitch was a strike. This one's mowed inside for ball one. Michael Smith, that's Mississippi State. He played 27 games, made 8 starts, hit 208. He's hitting 330 this summer for Santa Barbara with 13 RBI. He's a chance for a 14th ride here. Ball low, 2 balls and a strike. He was 0-for-3 in yesterday's game with 2 strikeouts and 2 walks. He did score 1 run. Could use a strikeout ride here and keep that runner at third base with 2 outs. It's a Marble from the stretch and a runner at third. 1 out, here's the 1-1 pitch.
hit to left field very well. Going back is Orencio Fisher. He will not get to it, and it is off the fence. Scores a run, a stand-up double for Michael Smith, and Santa Barbara takes a 2-1 lead on a ball smashed by Michael Smith off the fence in left field.
Park City Convention is tourism for all the players and athletes in the first NBC World Series. For information about food and lodging in Park City, visit parkcitykf.com. Park City is also the proud
Santa Barbara regains the lead.
Pitch clock out in right field. Second baseman, number 11.
Single jumps on the score. Now they're going to limit the damage. They're going to fast run Mason Smith. He's their second leading base stealer on the year with 11 stolen bases. He's off the second base. Marble staring him down. Now brings it home. Line to left field for a base hit. They're going to try and send it. Orencio Fisher up with it. And they will hold him at third base. It's cut off by Tony Maselli. So good job by O to get to that quickly and hold Smith at third base. They were going to send him, and then it's a good thing they didn't because he would have been dead meat. It's cut off by Maselli to keep
Orencio at first base. Upgrade for a chance to win a brand new 4K LG TV.
Now they've got first and third in electronics in Santa Barbara.
Win this TV valued at over $900 by purchasing our NBC World Series program and filling out your raffle slip. Each program earns one contest entry.
In fact, to the entire
also fans, just also another reminder that what they members of the Hutchinson Monarch
third,
staff
if he does take off for second base. They seem like a pretty aggressive team, although they only have 111 stolen bases.
He would like to donate to Kaiser Carmine.
So their team likes the steel bags, as the Mustangs with 147 this year.
Hutchinson Monarch staff members to make your donation.
Both teams usually pretty aggressive on the base paths. McFadden now jogs back to the dugout. Team disperses to their positions, and they would like a ground ball right here. Although
center fielder number one, Ryan Chandler,
is a left-hander with speed. He leads the team with 20 stolen bases. He will be tough to double up, especially a left-hander. First and third, one out. The nine-hole hitter Chandler, look at strike one, the outside corner. Top of the order is on deck for this Santa Barbara team. They already have four hits so far. Just one out here in the bottom of the second inning. 2-1 Santa Barbara here in the second round game at the NBC World Series. Marble checks first. There goes the runner. They're going to throw it down to second base, and they got it. Francisco Alvarez guns him down, and Michael Smith did not go home. A huge out for Dixon Marble and the Mustangs as Frankie Alvarez threw a dart to second base. And Jackson Schnurbusch applied the tag, and the Mustangs get a huge out. It was a called strike two to... There's a ball to Chandler. There's a strike, and now it's 1-2. Ron Sema gets gunned down by Francisco Alvarez. That is a humongous out. And again, Michael Smith, I think he played that wrong at third base as he looked at his head coach, Bill Pintard, at third base, the third base coach as well. He was kind of confused on why he did not go home, and they threw down to second base. Third ball outside for ball two. Two balls and two strikes. The Smith, as he went back to third base, and he did not go home, and kind of looked over at his head coach and manager. And I think he felt, or he knew that he kind of messed that one up. Ground ball towards second, should end the inning. Houston up with it. The first base in time, and the Mustangs get out of it. Just give up the one run. At the end of two, it's Santa Barbara 2 and St. Joseph 1 as we go to the third right here on 680 KFBQ. Orencio Fisher, first pitch swinging, and he lines one to left field in front of Meslani. The Mustangs now have their fourth in the game, the leadoff man on base for the first time in the game for St. Joseph. Dave Rigger back in Wichita, Lawrence Dumont Stadium, top of the third. 2-1
Santa Barbara. Center fielder number four, Jacob Richardson.
Line drive from left field off the bat of Orencio Fisher as he was first pitch swinging like he likes to do. And now the Mink League leader in stolen bases with 36 and 40 attempts is at first base. And the first base is now in time. Jacob Richardson up loops into left field his last time up, so he is one for one in the game. Here's the NBC. He is now two for four. He'll throw to first base in a very close play, but he's called safe. Mustangs and the Santa Barbara Foresters, third all-time meeting. Mustangs got run ruled by this club a year ago, first time and only time they've ever been run ruled here in Wichita. There is a 15-run rule after 5 and an 8-run rule after 7 here at the NBC World Series. Jacob Richardson bats left-handed. Orencio Fisher off of first base. The pitch
Fastball a little bit low. Otto, not a huge leg kick when he's from the stretch of the runner on base. A little bit of one, not a slide step, not a full leg kick. Now a quick snap throw to first base is not in time. For a guy that's only allowed 23 hits all season, the Mustangs have four now through 10 batters in this game. A couple of hard hit balls by Cassidy and Alvarez and also Orencio Fisher. There goes Orencio, a late steal, but he is going to swipe the bag. No, they're going to call him out. Boy, it looked like he might have got the hand in there, but they call him out. He took kind of a stutter step start. It was not a great start for Orencio Fisher. He obviously sped up, and now Matt Johnson going to talk to the umpire. Boy, it did look like he was going to get in there. The tag also was near the lower half of Orencio, and he slid head first. Orencio Fisher is called out. So Montalbano will gun him down, and Orencio's went out for the fifth time this year. Now 36 of 41 in stealing bases. Two ball and one strike count. Richardson got jammed here and fought it off, fouled it back. One out, nobody on base. Mustangs. That leadoff single erased with that caught stealing. Richardson. Two balls, two strikes now after the foul ball. Here's one Otto's pitch. Richardson swings a high fastball. He missed it and strikes out. He's trying high heat when he gets two strikes, and it's worked at least three times so far in the game. Otto now, after giving up the leadoff single, has two outs and just six pitches. Brings up Trent Hill, who ran into a 6-4-3 double play his last time up. 4-for-6 here in Wichita so far for the 4-for-5 day he had yesterday. Mustangs go lefty, lefty, lefty at 2-3-4 against the right-hander Glenn Otto. First pitch inside for ball one. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Just missed inside alone. Off speed again to Trent Hill. One run, four hits, no errors for the Mustangs. Two runs, four hits, no errors for Santa Barbara. 1-0 to Trent Hill, fastball high. 2-0 to count to Trent. Again, last year in the NBC, in the three games he played, he was 5-for-10, also picked up a save in their win over Alaska last season. He loves hitting in this ballpark. So one high away, and it will be. So that's ball four right there, so he's going to have a four-pitch walk. Where the Mustangs could have two on with one out for Ramsey Scott.
First base with
one on, two outs.
Ramsey Scott.
And he leads the Mustangs with five homers, 35 RBI. His first time up, he was out 4-3 in the ground out to their second baseman, Ron Zima. Trent Hill, no threat to steal. He's at first base. But at first base, he just kind of lunges back there. Not really a dive. Yesterday, Josh Cass got picked off at first. He tried to slide back, and it was like Velcro, just stuck in the turf. He was literally 2 feet from the bag when he tried to slide back head first. I'm guessing his teammates probably let him know about that a little bit. Fastball up and in, now five consecutive also owned by Glenn Otto. He's nearing 50 pitches here in the third inning, so they've got his pitch count where they want it right now. And not a big lead for Trent. He only has two steals and four attempts. Trent looks at the fastball for a strike. Well, something off of that one, though. Make sure he threw over the plate. 2-1 Santa Barbara here in the top of the third inning. Mustangs trail by one. Backman on base, but there's two outs. Trent Hill at first base. Go to first base. They must not know Trent real well. They keep throwing over there. In his college career, well, he did have 7 steals and 10 attempts at Lee University this past season. So he's proved me a little bit wrong. 2 out of 4 this summer. Ramsey swings a high fastball. He missed that one. Now it's one ball, two strikes to Ramsey Scott. Let's see if he can get a hold of one. A little windy today here in Wichita. It's obviously hot and humid. 90 degrees at first pitch. 91 at first pitch. 90 degrees right now. But when there is, which is breezing pretty good, it's blowing out to left field. 1-2 the count. The pitch to Ramsey Scott. Stays alive. Got jammed, fouled it back. Ramsey Scott still a one ball and two strike count as he is 0-for-1. Ramsey on the the season, hitting 291. Hit 298 this past year at Maple Woods. 10 homers, 43 RBI. Kate Girardeau made it. Got a curveball, and it's in the turf. They appeal. The umpire's out near second base. No way for him to tell, but he didn't have an angle, but there was no way he went around. Not even close. Now it's 2 balls and 2 strikes. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Mustangs down 2-1 with a runner at first base. Len Otto from the stretch for Santa Barbara. Fastball, ground ball to first base. It's loved by Stutter. He'll step of the bag, and that will retire the St. Joseph Mustangs in inning number 3. We're to the bottom of the third. St. Joseph trails Santa Barbara 2-1 here at the NBC World Series in Wichita on 680 KFQ. Shortstop number 13, John Holland, the leadoff man for the Santa Barbara Foresters, as he leads things off here in the third inning as well. He flew out to right fielder Trent Hill to start the game for the Foresters. Now he swings an off-speed pitch here and misses, and now speaking of no balls and two strikes. The first time through the order, the Foresters picked up 4 hits in their 2 innings, scored 2 runs, and left the man at third base in the second frame. Dixon's pitch, and just staying alive was Holland. Had to lunge for that one. He fouls it off back behind home plate. Dixon threw 32 pitches in the first 2 innings. No strikeouts, no walks so far for Marble. In the dirt. Ball 1 to John Holland. Holland is their shortstop. He plays his college baseball also in Mississippi State with Michael Smith. Holland went 0 for 4 in yesterday's game. He's now 0 for 5 here in Wichita. Two games. 1-2. Line to left field. Lorenzo Fisher goes over to his left. He reaches up, makes the grab on line drive. Nearly hit right at him. He'll make the catch.
Third baseman number 9, Matt Henderson.
Leadoff man is retired here in inning number 3. Dixon could use a nice 1-2-3 inning. Matt Henderson will hit as he had a triple on the right field line his last time up. Going back to Holland, he was a starter at Mississippi State at 246, visiting 344 this summer for the Foresters. 2-1 the score, Santa Barbara the lead. First pitch is a little bit low from Dixon Marble for ball 1. He asked the umpire, was that low? And shook his head. Dixon's pitch, there's a fastball for a strike. Just sneak that fastball up on you a little bit and throw a lot of off-speed junk. Sneak the fastball by you. 1 ball, 1 strike to count, 1 out, nobody on base for Santa Barbara here in the third. There's an off-speed pitch on the outside corner. 1-2 to count to Henderson, the third baseman, who plays at Santa Barbara Community College. He's now 3 for 6 here in Wichita. He picked up his first triple of the season, his last AB down the right field line. Swings it left-handed and looks at one low and away. 2 balls and 2 strikes to count from Dixon Marble. Then Matt Henderson, 5'10", 170-pound switch-hitting third baseman, batting left-handed. They set up inside, Frankie does, and he hits it to right center field. Coming over is Richardson, and Jacob will not get there. And it's going to go all the way by Trent Hill, and Jake will back him up for a double. Matt Henderson has 2 extra base hits. He's got a triple and a double in his first 2 ABs. A runner at second
base. First baseman number 7, Granger stuttered.
Again, less than 1 out. He took a 2-2 pitch to right center field that Richardson tried to get to, and they looked at Trent Hill, who tried to cut it off. He couldn't get to it, and then he took a backup Trent. Now Matt Johnson's going to go out and talk to the entire infield. Angelo Mustang is going to come out and talk to his entire team. Anderson well on his way to a cycle so far. He's got the hardest one out of the way with the triple, and now a double. Although this season, Henderson has not hit a home run. He didn't have one at Santa Barbara Community College either. So for him, that could be the hardest. Blake McFadden walks some balls out to the home plate umpire, has a tiny conversation with him, gives him a chuckle. Trying to get on his good side, right? 1 out, 1 off to Santa Barbara here in the bottom of the third inning. Second round of the NBC World Series, a winner's bracket game. St. Joseph going down 2-1. So bring up the Rangers stutter, who drove in a run. Vaughn with a ground out back in the opening frame. He was out 4-3 on that ground out to Jerry Houston. The first six outs, three were ground balls to Houston at second base. Center best left-handed plays at Texas State. That RBI that he had back in the first was his 40th of the season, which leads Santa Barbara. Now stepping off the rubber this time is Dixon Marble. Henderson at second base. He has 15 steals and 18 attempts. Will they try and get him to third with less than two outs again? They've had one like that the first two innings, and they've scored each time. Marble looks at second, brings it home. He doesn't go. Off-speed, called strike on the outside corner. Head of Granger stuttered, no balls and one strike. Stuttered this season is hitting 331, four homers, 40 RBI. Struck out 28 times, swings and misses through this one, an off-speed pitch again, no balls and two strikes. Stuttered has walked 22 times, his on-base percentage is at 444, on-base average. Seven doubles, a triple, and the four home runs that I just talked about. 2-1 Santa Barbara. Marble trying to keep it that way. Henderson to second base and one out. Ground ball toward Ramsey. He's got a first base. He bobbles it now. He knocks it down, and it will be an error on the Mustang first baseman. He went to it kind of awkwardly down the first baseline, back behind the bag.
Jeremy
stumbled just a bit, and that would be an error on Ramsey Scott as he boots it and ricocheted just too far away from him into foul ground. For him to pick it back up and step on the bag. It should have been an easy play for Ramsey, but it would be an error, the first in the Mustang. They had two yesterday. Now first and third with one out. Swing and a miss by Montalbano, the catcher. He popped up on the infield. His last time up, so he's 0-1. Caught by Francisco Alvarez down the first base line. He's a guy you can double up. Big kid at 6'8", 200 pounds. He's thick. Played 2 years at the University of Texas, and now he transferred to Tulane. Just like Jerry Houston at Mizzou, he had to sit out this past year for the Green Wave due to the NCAA transfer rule going from D1 to D1. He was on their team a year ago when they won the NBC World Series. Not a ton of guys, a handful. There were, I think, four position players from last year's club that are on this year's team. First and third, one out. They had the situation last time, just got the one run. It's the Marble and it's hammered right down the third baseline, but foul. He pulled that one right down by his manager. Foul ball makes it no balls and two strikes. Use a ground ball. Dixon Marble has tried to work around some trouble these first three innings. His team now down 2-1, trying to keep it that way. Runners in first and third, one out. And it checks swing, it hit his bat twice. Check swing, it hit his bat, he kind of came around and hit it again. And it hit the plate as well, so a foul ball. That's probably a break for the Mustangs. It goes down that third baseline. He probably comes in to score. Henderson does from third. They may or may not get the out of first base. They set up way outside. Francisco Alvarez does. Here's the 0-2 pitch. And a tapper toward third, or excuse me, toward short. The only play is going to be at first base. Ramsey Scott has to come off at first and make the tag, but it was not hit sharp enough to short. And Jackson Schnurber's only play was a first base on another ground out RBI, and that's why you get a runner to the third base with less than two out. They've done all three innings, Tyler, and that runner has scored in all three innings. 3-1 now, Santa Barbara. Montalbano gets the RBI, his 36th of the season. Again, that's the problem. The error now comes back to hit the Mustangs. That should have been the third out of the inning. So instead of it being 2-1 at the end of three, it's now 3-1. They're trying to keep it that way. It stutters at second base. First pitch was a ball to Ivan Meslani. Got a single up the middle of his last time up. Dixon Marble from the stretch checks second base. Two outs, a runner at second base for Santa Barbara. And it's lined to center field. Richardson to his right, accelerates, leaps up, and he'll make the catch. On the run in left center field as they shaved him to the right side. He ran it down, and that will retire the Foresters in the inning. But they get one run on one hit. There is one error, and they leave one. At the end of three complete, Santa Barbara leads St. Joseph 3-1.
All right, baseball around the clock. 2016 on the cold dirt, baseball around the clock.
First pitch of the fourth inning is in the turf here at Lawrence Dumont Stadium. I am Dave Riggert as the Mustangs trail Santa Barbara 3-1 here in the top of the fourth inning. And now Josh Cassie, a line drive, one hopper off the glove, the shortstop, and Holland couldn't come up with it. And Josh Cassie has a two-hit game here as he lines one to get up the middle on one hop off the glove of Holland. This infield,
third baseman number 34,
very fast.
Tony
Nasselli hard by Cassie. And not able to handle it, so a base hit to lead off the fourth inning because they've had the leadoff man on in now two of their four innings. But Renzo Fisher was caught stealing his last time up. Mustangs with their leadoff man on here in the fourth inning for Tony Maselli. Anthony's 0 for 1 struck out. He was ahead three balls and a strike with Cassidy at second base, and then Cassidy got the third base on a wild pitch back in the second inning as Josh had come in to score anyway, but Maselli ends up striking out. Now he takes a big swing at this one, and he misses. Ball on a strike down to Tony. Maselli played eight games as all this past year for Boston College. Made two starts, was 3 for 12 in those games, but homer and six RBIs and just 12 ABs. He took advantage of his opportunities at Boston College. Fastball inside, two balls and a strike. I would imagine he and Scott Brown, who they've played a lot as freshmen at BC, will play much more as their careers continue. The Eagles are 27-27 this past year, 10-19 in the ACC. But at first base is not in time. Cassidy this season does have 9 steals and 11 attempts. That's the most he's had in his 2 years of the Mustangs. Glenn Otto, a 2-1 count to Maselli. There's a fastball right down the middle. 2-2 the count. I don't nearing 60 pitches here in the fourth inning, so they're making this pitch count up. Nobody warming the pen, obviously, yet, but getting the pitch count up, making him work. 2-2 pitch, Maselli is inside. Now it's full, 3 balls and 2 strikes. He's struck out 4 so far through 3 innings, 3+ innings, and he has walked 2. He also has 2 wild pitches, and has allowed 5 base hits in the game. Mustangs have done a good job against him, only 1 run to show for it. Now a pitch high and a 7-ball walk. So Glenn Otto having some control issues. He's walked 2 of his last 4 batters.
Catcher number 23, Francisco Alvarez.
And now the pitching coach of the Foresters will trot out to the pitcher's mound as Francisco Alvarez will hit for the Mustangs. He drove in the only run with a 2-out double left field. This play by Tyler Nislani. Mustangs baseball here on 680 KFQ is brought to you by St. Joe Frontier Casino. Also by Summit Truck Group, by Walton Ford in Savannah, by Rock Ridge Steel, by Reese Nichols Real Estate, by Horizon Outdoor, and also by Duval Lawn Care. Mustangs and Santa Barbara Foresters here in the second round of the NBC World Series. About an hour and a half after the scheduled first pitch is when the first pitch took place tonight. The Mustangs originally were told they were going to play the 10 o'clock game this evening, which means the 10 o'clock game this evening won't get started until about 11:30 at the earliest. And that's if they stay on schedule. So they're an hour and a half behind in the scheduled start times. The Mustangs get back in this one down just 3-1, but have a chance with 2-1, nobody out. Jeremy Montalbano out in front of home plate, the catcher. He makes signals to his defense on how they want to play it. Francisco Alvarez, the double the left field, a ground rule double that one hopped the wall. Disposed by Nislani. That's one of the 5 hits so far for St. Joseph, his second here in Wichita. He squares the bunt, pulls it back. Let's see if they try and get 2 in a scoring position. 1-0, no strikes to count. Glenn Otto again having some trouble finding the strike zone right. He had 12 walks coming in, and now has 3 so far through 3-plus innings. Let's see if they try and sacrifice again. He squares the bunt, gets it down, beautiful bunt, and it's going to just roll foul. Boy, on the turf, it just had a little bit of spin toward the third base line for the Mustang dugout, and boy, that was almost going to be a base hit had it got down. A beautiful bunt, but it just spun into foul territory for a foul ball and a strike. So Matt Johnson playing some small ball, trying to get two guys in a scoring position with just one out. And those tied runs in a scoring position in a 3-1 game here in the top of the fourth inning. Francisco Alvarez digs in. We'll see if they keep the sacrifice on. Selly out for first, Cassie out for second. Now he's going to swing away and misses this time. So they took the sacrifice off. He swings and misses. It's a one ball and two strike. No, they did call a strike on the first pitch. So when he squared the bunt and pulled it back, they did call that a strike. They put ball on the scoreboard, but they called it a strike.
Second baseman number 14, Jerry Houston.
So he will strike out swinging. That's why they took it off, obviously. Got the sacrifice. Francisco Alvarez strikes out. That's a big strikeout. They could not get the runners to second, third. Now Jerry Houston, who walked his last time up, was left at the second base. Back in the second, we'll dig in. He had an infield single of his one hit yesterday against Hutchinson. Pitch is hot. And now the Foresters do have some action in their bullpen. He's up to 64 pitches with one out here in the fourth inning, and he's been a little erratic. Mustangs haven't taken advantage of that just yet, though. Just one run on the scoreboard. One ball, no strikes to count. Otto comes set. Jerry Houston checks his swing. It's outside. Two balls and no strikes. Warming up is Tyler McGill, sophomore or junior to be at Loyola Marymount. He is from Huntington Beach, California. He looks at 6'7", 230 right in. Two balls and no strikes to Houston. Fastball, boy, he got a pitch that he liked and he just missed it, fouled it back. And a 2-0 fastball right down the middle and just missed it. Two balls and a strike with one out. The tying run's on base, but at first and second, they were there with nobody out, and now they're there with one. And fielded double play depth, trying to end the inning. Houston. Swings it right-handed. Ooh, he looks at one high and inside it looked like they're going to call it a strike. It's a called strike. The strike zone has been pretty high. Like the letters, even maybe sometimes above the letters, which you don't get that called a ton. Scoreboard has it wrong again. It's a two ball on two strike count. One out, two on. Need to get something done here. Otto looks twice at second base, the leg kick. Got jammed. It's down the right field line. This could be trouble. It's going to drop for a base hit. They're going to send Cassie, and now they will hold him. But Selly goes, and they'll throw to third base, and Cassie scores anyway. Cassie and Matt Johnson had some miscommunication. And Maselli took off for third the entire time. There was going to be a rundown somewhere, but the throw was cut off and it went to third. And the Mustangs got a break as Cassidy comes in to score on a bloop single right field by Jerry Houston. And it makes it a 3-2 game here in the fourth inning. Ooh. Boy, if he throws that thing home, Cassidy is dead meat. They probably have him in a rundown because he was going to go, and then he got held up. Matt Johnson told him it's my bad after the play. The Mustangs get a break, and Maselli, a good base runner, to get to third base. He looked initially and saw that he was going to send Cassidy. At the last second, he held him, but Cassidy was way too far in the line. Maselli was going to take off toward third base. So he gets there with one out. And there goes Houston, and they will let him have second base. So now two in a scoring position. Jerry Houston in a scoring position for Jackson Schnurbusch. St. Joseph Mustangs have a chance to tie or take the lead here in this fourth inning. It's a 3-2 game. Ball was high for a 1-0 count to Jackson Schnurbusch. Jackson struck out his first time up, swinging a high fastball this time and misses. He's having a hard time catching up with a high fastball right now. Runners at second and third of one out. It's a 3-2 game. They're warming up Tyler McGill a little quicker now in the Foresters bullpen. Otto now at 70 pitches. He steps off. Herbert will step out and readjust the batting gloves. He digs in right-handed. One ball, one strike, one out. Two on, one in already. 3-2 Santa Barbara here in the fourth. Otto's pitch, high fastball, popped him up and foul ground, left side of the infield, and it won't quite get to the net, but Montalbano never had any clue where it was, so Jackson Sturbridge will get new life. Foul ball makes it a ball and two strikes.
Me and Christy Village is in town.
Matt Johnson.
The very best in retirement
saw something in Sturbridge.
Unique communities located in Wichita.
Let's talk to him a second.
They offer an option to fit every lifestyle.
Give him some advice, and now going out to talk to Glenn Otto, who's Montalbano, the catcher. Mustangs with a great opportunity here in the fourth inning. They've out hit the Foresters so far, though they have one more AB. Now Coach Johnson is talking to the home plate umpire about something. Mustangs down 3-2. Mixon Marbles worked around some damage each inning. He's allowed one run every frame. Mustangs a chance right now. It's a one ball and two strike count. One out here at the top of the fourth inning. Selling the tying run at third base. The go-ahead run is Hitchin at second. And a curveball in the dirt, and they'll have to throw down to first base. Montalbano does, and he throws him out. The strikeout, as Jackson Schnurbush will strike out for the second time in the game. And a good job by Montalbano, who threw him out and made sure he held Maselli at third base. So now it's up to Orencio Fisher with two down. Schnurbush has struck out twice now in the game. The St. Joseph Mustangs down one, two-man scoring position. Otto trying to work out of this jam. And keep his team ahead. Rancio Fisher loves to jump on the first pitch. Let's see if he does. He throws him a fastball on it. Had a base hit to left his last time up. Struck out in the first. Was 1-for-2 against Otto. Off speed stays high this time. One ball, no strikes. 3-2 game here in the fourth inning. Mustangs down one. Otto a long look in. Montalbano, that's a sign down, now a line drive to center field. Going back, now coming in is Chandler, he'll make a basket catch as he misplayed that just a little bit as he went back first, had to come back in, and Orencio Fisher will fly up to center field, and that will leave two Mustangs in scoring position here in this inning. At the end of 3.5, St. Joseph down just one, they trail Santa Barbara, California, by a score of 3-2 from the NBC World Series here in Wichita. Six, seven, eight for Santa Barbara here in the bottom half of the fourth innings. They lead 3-2 against the St. Joseph Mustangs. It's a two-ball and no-strike count to David Greer, the DH, who was 0-for-1 of the game. He was out 4-3 on a ground ball to Jerry Houston. His last time up back in the second for the first out in that frame. 3-2 Santa Barbara here at the NBC World Series in the second round. Checks his swing in that pitch. He is a little bit high. They appealed on to first base, and they're going to say he did not go around. Umpire a little inconsistent right now with his balls and strikes. He got a little high the strike zone did last inning, and that one was like a pretty good pitch. There's one right down the middle. Three balls and a strike, leadoff batter here in the fourth inning. Santa Barbara's only had their leadoff man on one of the three innings so far, but they've scored one run in each inning. They've had a runner at third base. There's a call and strike inside. They've had a runner at third base with one out in all three innings, and that runner has scored. The Mustangs have not been able to take advantage of that. They've had that opportunity twice. They're not able to do it. And now, a lucky miss just off the plate. Dixon gives a big smile. He didn't agree with that. Now the Mustangs not a little happy with the strike zone.
Right fielder number three, Michael Smith.
So leadoff man on for the second time in four innings, second time in the last three. He's been the second guy when the off man didn't get on. Henderson had a triple and a double. He scored two of the runs so far. Here's the seven-hole hitter, Michael Smith. He doubled his last time up. He is 1-for-1 in the game. First pitch is an off-speed pitch. One ball and no strikes to count. But our first base is not in time. And Michael Smith plays at Mississippi State. Franklin, Tennessee. Double was to left center field his last time up. Fastball, got the outside corner. That's a called strike. One ball, one strike to count. Nope, it's 0-2. I thought it said the scoreboard. They must have switched scoreboard operators because he has been off a lot today. I need to just go with my gut, what I thought happened. No balls and two strikes to Michael Smith, the right fielder for Santa Barbara. Foresters again, 36-7. Their fewest losses in team history. Now a high fly ball to shallow left field coming in as a Renzio pitcher. Reach up and make the grab, just left of his head, and that will be the first out of the inning. Greer State's put at first base as they try and...
Second baseman number 11, Jones,
to the game, have a quick inning despite the leadoff walk. One on, one out, and that brings up the second baseman, John Frontzima. He bats right-handed. He plays at UC Irvine. Chucky Kemp, what is their mascot? UC Irvine? The Anteaters. They were in the College World Series not that long ago. UC Irvine this past season were 33-23, 15-9 in the Big West. Where the first base is not in time, Greer is back. He has six steals and six attempts, does not go here. Fastball low away. Dixon out 61 pitches with one out in the fourth, so his pitch count getting up as well. We'll see if they go to their bullpen or not after four innings with first-round pitcher Glenn Otto, because he now is up over 70 pitches through four innings. He got in the jam, though, and kept his team in front 3-2. We're in the fourth inning, still 3-2, and another one first base. The 1-0 count to the Santa Barbara second baseman. Marble, a long look in as Frankie Alvarez got the sign from pitching coach Blake Nierfad and relays that to Marble. The 1-0 and out to the first base again. Dixon told me earlier in the year that he has never shook off a Mustang catcher's career with the Mustangs. And it's been a 3-year career. Blake McFadden calling the pitches this year. He just calls whatever they tell him to throw. So one ball, no strike. There goes Greer, and a foul ball. Team have fouled it back to the screen. So Greer will retreat back to first base. Greer going to Arizona State. He had four steals and eight attempts for the Sun Devils as he started 49 games for them. Arizona State has been a power in Division I baseball. They finished 35-23, 18-12 in the Pac-12. Ooh, that one just missed. Dixon's not real happy with the strike zone right now. His body language is not great. Two balls and a strike. It has been a little inconsistent. So one thing coaches and players want, they just want the consistency. Wherever that strike zone is going to be, just be consistent. First base again. David Greer gets back easily. Frankie Alvarez has gunned down one man so far in this game. There he goes. It's a hit and run. Popped up to shallow right. Going back is Houston. He's got time to get there. He grabs it, and he'll throw to first base for a double play as Greer didn't know where the ball was. And that's going to be a quick 1-2-3, and it's not the conventional way. So Greer just stayed at second base, had no clue where the ball was, and he was doubled up easily after the catch by Jerry Houston, shallow right field. Through four innings, Santa Barbara leads St. Joseph 3-2. Here from the NBC World Series in Wichita.
Leading off the St. Joe center fielder number 4, Jacob Richardson.
2-3-4 for the Mustangs here in inning number 5, top of the fifth. Santa Barbara leading St. Joseph by a score of 3-2, first pitch in the dirt. They appealed down to third, and they're going to say he went around. He might have checked his swing, and Coach Johnson even kind of shook his head like, no, he didn't go around, but they're going to say he did, so let's swing and miss. And Jacob Richardson is 1-for-2 so far in the game. He swings at an off-speed pitch low and inside. He's having trouble with that pitch. In his first couple ABs, he got jammed, but popped one off to left field for a bloop single his first time up. His second time up, he struck out back in the third. He's down 0-2 and one of the turf again here at North Dumont Stadium. Mustang center fielder will lead things off here in the fifth, and now looks like a called strike on the inside. He gets struck out. That is the sixth strikeout now for Glenn Otto through 4 1/3 innings. He has walked three as a two wild pitches so far in the game. Now Trent Hill will bat with the bases empty. This is the third time through the order
that we've seen them twice.
They've had success. They've out-hit Santa Barbara through four innings. They trail 3-2, some mistakes by St. Joseph. This Hill looks at one low, and now he's ahead two balls and no strikes. Trent's 0-for-1 in the game. He walked his last time up. Now 4-for-6 here at this tournament. 9-for-16 all-time here at the NBC World Series, and now it's a 3-0 count to Trent. He saw four pitches for balls his last at bat. Now it's a 3-0 count to Trent here. I'm guessing they saw him yesterday. We can do some research and find out his numbers. And I'm guessing they're going to be pretty careful with him. Trent puts it a strike on the outside corner. Now a pitch high. Fourth walk in the game for Otto. Tying runs on base for Ramsey Scott. And then Josh Cassidy, who's 2-for-2 in the game. Now they're going to come out. That might be it.
First baseman number 32,
Ramsey Scott, warming up in the pen. And I think they're going to go to the bullpen. They will. This pitching change is brought to you by St. Joe Frontier Casino. It's the fun place to play. Visit St. Joe Frontier Casino, Highland Avenue, exit 7 from I-229 in St. Joseph. For more information, visit stjoefrontiercasino.com. We'll tell you about Tyler McGill, I should say, when we return, one-on-one after the Mustangs in the top of the fifth inning, as they trail 3-2 to the Santa Barbara Foresters here at the NBC World Series. While Tyler McGill is warming up, I do want to give thoughts and prayers to Kaiser Carlisle, who is the bat boy for the Liberal BJs, who got struck in the head yesterday from an on-deck batter and is in critical condition in a hospital here in Wichita. So our thoughts and prayers are to him and his family. The KC initials are on the scoreboard here at Lawrence Dumont Stadium. A very scary situation yesterday here. It was in the game, a couple games after the Mustangs yesterday, but very scary situation. He's in critical position right now at a hospital here in Wichita, so thoughts and prayers that he and his family is hopefully can make it through this tragedy that's happened here at Lawrence Dumont Stadium in the NBC World Series. St. Joseph down one here in the fifth inning, top of fifth with one out. New pitcher is Tyler McGill. He's a sophomore from Loyola Marymount University, Huntington Beach, California. 6'7", 230. On the summer, he's 2-2 with a 3.81 ERA, 28 Ks, 13 walks, and 28 and a third. Right-hander to bring in against Ramsey Scott. So we think they might bring a lefty in against Scott, but Cassidy is on deck, and then I guess Maselli a lefty too, so but three of the next hitters are lefties. First pitch in the dirt for ball one. Tyler McGill, the new pitcher. We'll tell him more about McGill as we continue. But at first base is not in time as he'll slide back in for safety. McGill has allowed 23 hits. He has one save this year. This is his 10th appearance of the summer for Santa Barbara. But at first base, Hill late getting back, and he is just safe. Wow. Boy, the umpire, too, like, waited for a second, and he thought about it, and then he's just like, yeah, let's flip a coin, and we'll call him safe. That was an awkward call, because normally if he's out, he calls it right away, or safe, whatever, but didn't that time. Now down left field line, slice foul, and a bad play by Steve D'Amico. An error on D'Amico. Mustang closer down the left field line. Yeah, I think Ramsey might have broke his bat. The second broken Mustang bat. Good thing it's the last week of the season. Foul ball makes it 1-1. Ramsey in yesterday's game went 1-for-4 with a walk, hitting 291 now on the year. He's 0-for-2 in this game with two groundouts, one to second, one to third base.
First baseman number 32, Ramsey Scott.
Ramsey, a 1-1 count. One out, tying run at first base in Trent Hill. He had a one-out walk after a move. Our called strike three to Jacob Rich in the start. This fifth inning. Second pitcher for Santa Barbara, and now a swing and a slice down the left field line again. This one gets out of the stadium as he was laid on an outside fastball. Ramsey got to such a hot start this year. He was 7 for his first 10 this season, and boy, he was hitting over 400 for a long time, over 300. Just under 300 now, 291. And off-speed pitch got a foul tip in the glove of Montalbano, and a strikeout for Tyler McGill as he has come on in relief. Well, that's a big, big out. Ramsey could not get a runner into scoring position. And that'll be Josh Cassidy. He's had a good day. He's 2-for-2. I talked about the incident.
That's happening hitter number 17, Josh Cassidy.
Liberal BJ's that boy, and now for the rest of the tournament, I believe. There aren't any here. They're just getting the bat boys, and probably the right thing to do. Go to first base is Trent Hill. Goes head first safely, back to first base. Kaiser Carlisle, again, the young boy that got struck yesterday. First pitch to Cassidy. He's probably mad they went to the bullpen because he was 2-for-2 against Glenn Otto. First pitch is a called strike. Cassidy now 3 hits here at the NBC World Series. He's 3-6. Went 1-for-4 in yesterday's game, but has an RBI. 2-for-2 so far today. Big swing and a miss there. High fastball. He's down 0-2. McGill again 6-7. Has good velocity. Santa Barbara had a lot of arms in their pit. They list 13 pitchers on their roster. Called strike three, outside corner. Two called strike threes in the inning, and the Mustangs strike out for all three outs in this frame. We are through 4.5, halfway home here in Wichita in the second round of the NBC World Series as Santa Barbara leads St. Joseph by a score of 3-2 here on 680 KDK. It'll be 9-1-2 for Santa Barbara here in the bottom half of the fifth inning as they lead the St. Joseph Mustangs 3-2 here in the second round of the NBC World Series. Dixie Marble after his fifth inning of work. And a fly ball to shallow center field. Houston goes out, and he will make the catch on the run on the Wichita Wing Nuts logo in shallow center field. The Wing Nuts home team here is Lawrence Dumont.
Shortstop number 13, John Holland.
They are gone for a couple weeks as they are an independent league team. Be home to the Wichita Wranglers, the Royals double-A affiliate. First pitch foul ball, and then a fly ball to shallow center field up on the bat of Ryan Chandler. Now back to the top of the order. This is John Holland, the shortstop. Holland, his last time up, lined out to Orencio Fisher in left, and then flew out to right to Trent Hill back in the first. So he is 0-for-2 against Dixon Marble. Boy, the strike zone again, it seems to change here in this game, or it seems to have changed. There's a called strike and a pitcher looked outside. And now Holland's going to take his time and step out. He looks back at the home plate umpire. No balls and two strikes. Marble had an unconventional 1-2-3 inning with a double play last half inning. Now he gets his first strikeout in the game. Alvarez off a throw down to first base. It's low, and Ramsey Scott has it. And he will make the catch for the
third baseman number 9, Matt Henderson.
Second out, and now some talking between Ramsey Scott and Holland as Ramsey had to go down to get it. Holland's running toward first base, and Ramsey really had no other place to go, and then they kind of ran into each other a little bit. So they're jawing a little bit, and Ramsey talks to the first base coach for a second for Santa Barbara. First two batters retired in an inning for the first time in the game, and we're in the fifth. Dixon Marble worked out of some damage. This team is just down by one. All one now, called strike in half. Now Matt Henderson's done most of the damage in this game. He has two of the runs scored. He has a double, a triple, and two runs scored. The 1-1 pitch to Henderson, and there's a called strike number two on the outside. Henderson can use a quick pitch inning too, a low pitch inning. He's 8 so far, 72 pitches now here through 4 2/3. Here's the 1-2. Tries a curveball outside. It's now 2-2. Mustangs about hit Santa Barbara. 6-5, a trail 3-2. St. Joseph with one error in the game. Again, they have three extra base hits, which helped out. Eight runners to third base with less than two down. The 2-2 checks his swing and is outside. It is now a 3-ball-and-2-strike count to Matt Henderson, the third baseman. He is the only one in this lineup that is not at a Division I school right now, but he is signed to play at Florida State. He's from Santa Barbara Community College. And now Dixon lost him. He was ahead 1-2 and threw three consecutive off-speed pitches outside for
first baseman number 7, Granger Stutter.
And that's dangerous now with 3 and 4 coming up. Putting a man at first base with two down. Henderson on the year has 15 steals and 18 attempts. Does not have a big lead right now when I throw to first base. But Stutter leads the team with 40 RBI, one in this game. Second with 4 home runs this year. And then Montalbano, who is on deck, has 7 homers, which leads the team in the second with 36 RBI. There goes a runner. He got a humongous jump, and Alvarez has no chance. He won't even throw down. It was almost like Dixon's out of a windup the way that Henderson got a start in arena football when they get the start for the line of scrimmage. It was almost like he was running before anything else was happening. Mitch was inside for ball one. Henderson, second base now in scoring position. Called strike outside corner. Now Dixon's got to work around this. The runner in scoring position and their 3-hole batter up. Granger Stutter, 331 average. 281, 11 jacks at Texas State. He is from Buda, Texas. Takes a big swing there and fouls it back behind home plate. B-U-D-A, Buda, Texas. Foul ball makes it 1-2. 1-2 the count to Stutter, the first baseman for Santa Barbara. And keep this a 1-run deficit through 5. Check second, the pitch, in the dirt. Evens it up 2-2. Dixon now nearing 80 pitches. Nobody warming in the pen now for the Mustangs, though. If we can get through this inning and maybe get you one more, that'd probably be about it. Turn over the bullpen the last 3 innings. Hopefully get the offense going a little bit. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Dixon's going to twirl towards second base, doesn't throw. Henderson not a big lead, nobody was covering. Barber with single runs in the first 3 innings. Mustangs got 1 in the second, 1 in the fourth. Marvin's 2-2 pitch. Ooh, just missed low. He's been ahead of both Henderson and Stutter. 1-2, but now it's been 3-2 to both, but he eventually obviously walked Henderson at second base, and now it's a 3-2 count to Stutter. Left-handed first baseman pops him foul off of third in foul territory. Maselli on the run will make the catch in front of the stands in foul territory. He's a fantastic defensive third baseman. That's a good play down the line in foul territory, and that will retire Stutter and the Foresters here in the fifth. After 5, St. Joseph down 3-2 to Santa Barbara here in the second round of the NBC World Series in Wichita. Tony Maselli leads things off for the Mustangs here in the 6th as they trail Santa Barbara. Last score 3-2. Back at Lawrence Dumont Stadium. 1-0 the count to Maselli. Now swings and misses. That's a 1-1 count to the Mustang third baseman who made a great play in foul territory his last time up. His last time out in the field. How often do you see that? Somebody makes a great defensive play and then they're hit off the next inning. Foul ball over by the Forrester dugout. Interesting fact, this is the first game here in 2015 for Mustangs. And this is game number 52. The first game this year they've been in the third base dugout. Ball outside makes it 2-2. At home they're in the first base dugout. Every road game in the Mink they're in the first base dugout. And they were in the first base dugout yesterday. There's the 2-2 from McGill. Swung on a missed strikeout. As McGill has come on and struck out the three batters that he has faced so far in the game on just 12 pitches. Mustangs now in the game have struck out 10 times. And we're only in the sixth inning, so they have struck out way too many times. Otto struck out 7, and now Aguilo struck out the first three batters he's faced. Alvarez swings and misses. As we pitch outside. McGill and Pleasant Loyola Marymount, he has struck out now 31 in 29 and 1/3 innings this summer for Santa Barbara. Fastball foul back, just right of us up here in the press box. Makes it 1-2. Marbles through 5 innings now, has allowed 5 hits, 3 runs, 2 are earned, 1 strikeout, 2 walks. So he's done his job up to this point. Let's see if the offense can get something going. They've been able to hit the ball, but they've struck out too many times, especially with runners in scoring position. The ball high, and now it's 2 balls and 2 strikes to Francisco Alvarez. Frankie had a double, drove in a run back in the second, with 2 down, a ball misplayed by Neslani. Down the right field line, this should be fair, and it is a fair ball down the right field line. Frankie will head to second and make the turn, and he will try for 3. It's overthrown for the cutoff man, and he will get there. It's a triple for Francisco Alvarez, and for Frankie, his second triple of the season, and his second triple in his 2-year Mustang career. Great hustle by Francisco Alvarez, but also he missed the cutoff that Michael Smith did, who also made a mistake earlier when Cassidy scored, when they could have had a rundown if he throws to home instead of third base. So he's made a couple of mistakes, but a triple for Francisco Alvarez. So the tying run at third base with 1 out for Jerry Houston. The infield is back. They're in the corners, but back on the in the middle. A ground ball up the middle can score a run and tie the game up. They've had 3 chances at this, done it only 1 time so far. A 1-1, Houston swings and misses. 1 ball, 1 strike to count to Jerry. 1-for-1 in the game. Had a base hit to right his last time up, stole a bag, and walked in the second. So he's been on base both times. Jackson Schnurbusch is on deck. 3-2 lead for Santa Barbara. Fastball high, now 2-1. Houston came on late this season, and he's raised the average from the 225-ish range to now 274. He drove in the winning run in the Sedalia game on the road that final Sunday of the regular season. Fouls no back, just wide of us. Getting closer to us, though, here in the move. Now it's a 2-2 count to Houston. Sitting out this past year at Mizzou, a chance to start for the Tigers, who were a very young team. Finished 30-28, 15-15 in the SEC this past season. See if he can get the job done here. Fastball in the dirt, good stop by Montalbano. Now it's a full count with Schnurbusch on deck. 1 out, Alvarez at third base. Mustangs down 3-2. In the top of the sixth inning. And now the infield is going to come in. So on a 3-2 count, they will bring the infield in. So if Houston can take advantage of the pitch, and it's fouled off the right side. Houston 12 RBIs. Again, he had the winning RBI in the 10th inning of that game that Sunday in Sedalia, back on the 19th, and then had 2 RBIs in the Nink League Championship game. They went over Nevada 10-7. So he's had 3 RBIs here in the late season. Crunch time situations. Here's a 3-2 again. Chopped it off of his foot, foul. Over by Jackson Schnurbusch. He's on the on-deck circle. So a good battle here between McGill and Houston. Still just 1 out. A 1-out triple by Francisco Alvarez down the right field line. Action in the Forster's bullpen again. Cody Krause is warming up. He plays at Florida International. Here's the 3-2 again. Curveball missed high. Runners at first and third now. The one thing that does, it puts the infielders back.
Jackson Sherman.
But also, They're in double play depth, and that could end the inning without scoring a run. But it does put them back and get to the hole at second or short. Should be able to drive in a run. Jackson's 0 for 2 with two strikeouts. He had a similar situation his last time up, as he was up with runners at second and third and one out, and he struck out. And in this exact same situation last time, Jerry Houston stole second base by the throw. Let's see if they do it again. Does not go here. Schnurbusch, good swing, fouls it back. Got jammed, though, on a fastball in her half. Boy, the Mustangs have had a lot of base runners. They've out-hit Santa Barbara 7-5. Five walks as well by Forrester pitching, but only two runs to show for it. First and third, one out. Got to take advantage of this right now here in the sixth inning. On the first base as Houston goes back without a slide. Crowd's no longer warming up in the pen now for the Foresters of Santa Barbara, California. Seven losses all year long. Mustangs giving them all they want here in the top of the sixth inning. Chance to tie it in this inning. Houston, boy, he took a step towards second base in the snap throw to first base and just gets back in time. Again, he stole second in this situation without a throw last time up. On the season now, he has 16 steals and 17 attempts. Not a big leap. Doesn't go. Schnurbusch looks at strike two. Fastball outside. The outside corner, now he's down 0-2. So Jackson's had a heck of a time to play so far in this game. This is his first appearance against Tyler McGill. Fastball just missed outside. Ooh, a tough one to take. That strike zone a little bit inconsistent. Just off the plate that time, one ball, two strikes. Schnurbusch has 22 RBI, so despite the average just above 200, he has still driven in 22 runs this season. Here's the 1-2. Outside, two balls and two strikes. So creeping back into this count, should get a much better pitch to hit right now. McGill now to 22 pitches here in this frame after he struck out the first three batters that he faced, and the third coming in this inning. 2-2. There goes Houston down the right field line, but foul. But inside out that ball to right field and just missed it as he hit it wide right. Houston was off on that pitch. He retreats back to first base. Foul ball keeps the count two balls and two strikes. Laurencio Fisher is on deck. Boy, they got to take advantage of this. McGill, there goes Houston again. Fastball, he swung on and missed. He strikes out. He's 0 for 3 with three strikeouts.
Left fielder number 44, Laurencio Fisher.
Houston steals the base. So now a base hit could give the Mustangs the lead. But there are two outs. Fisher's 1 for 3 in the game. Same situation last time he came up in the fourth inning, and he flew out to center field. He had a base at the left, back in the third was Pat Stealing, and then struck out in the first against Otto. Let's see if O can come through here. First pitch, he sees a fastball. Boy, looked inside, but some called strike. Laurencio with bad body language after that called strike. O has 15 RBI. He has scored 42 runs, so lead the Mustangs, hitting 281. Hit 359 at Missouri Western this past season. All right, outside this time, it's low and away. One ball, one strike to Laurencio Fisher. It was 2 for 4 yesterday's game with a strikeout and a walk. He has 3 base hits so far here in Wichita this season. The 1-1. Right down the middle. Boy, that was a good one. And no doubt, called strike that time. Must have been looking for something else. As they say, ducks on the pond here in the sixth for the Mustangs. But now it's a 1-2 count to Laurencio Fisher. 3-2 Santa Barbara lead. Tying run 90 feet away. The going go-ahead run 180 feet away. And now a fly ball. It's going to get a playoff to the right side. It's amongst the spectators. McGill at 28 pitches in this inning. So they've made him work, but again, he has not allowed a run. And he He's one strike away from getting out of the jam. Gave up the triple, then the walk, got the strikeout of Schwerbusch. The four outs that he's recorded have been strikeouts. Lorenzo Fisher down 1-2 with two down and 2-1, both in scoring position. Blown away. 2-2 the count. Jacob Richardson is on deck. He has struck out twice in the game. The Mustangs have struck out 11 times in this contest through 5 2/3 innings. Gills, 2-2 pitch, fastball, bouncing ball up the middle, and it will be a tough play for Holland, and he throws it high! He came off the bag! A run will score, and the St. Joseph Mustangs have tied the game at 3 here at the top of the 6th inning. Boy, a good throw, I think, gets it. It was a very close play, but Holland had to just come up off the bag barely on a high throw from Stutter to come off the bag on the throw from Holland. And boy, the Mustangs get a break there. And the turf that time sped up the ball, made it a tough play for Holland. And now it's a 3-3 game here in inning number 6. We'll see how they officially score that. I would guess error since it brought him off the bag. And now Jacob Richardson could give the Mustangs the lead for the first time in the game. Lorenzo at first base, we'll see if they send it. He doesn't go here. Jacob looks at a first pitch strike on the outside corner. No official ruling yet, and it will give an error. I thought they probably would. The Mustangs have tied the game on an error by John Holland, the shortstop. 0-1, they throw to first base. It was going to be a close play, so he had to hurry and just threw it high. Balls and a strike to Jacob Richardson. He is 0-4, making 1-3 in the game, the hoop single left field. Has struck out twice. There goes Lorenzo. Ground ball right side of the infield, and it's going to be foul as he pulled it down the first base line. Jacob is now down 0-2. He had a big two-out single up the middle in their three-run fourth inning yesterday. See if he gets a big two-out base hit right here. All 8 runs yesterday was for two outs. First one today. Richardson stays alive. Boy, he shot that one foul into the stands right over the Mustang dugout. He stays alive. McGill now at 33 pitches in this inning. Boy, struck out Maselli, and they've made him work since that point in time. Houston third base, Fisher at first. There goes Lorenzo. In the dirt, gets away. Good stop by Montalbano. Stand up at second base. So now they've got 2 in scoring position here in the 6th inning. St. Joseph have tied the game here in the 6th. As ball 1 to Jacob Richardson. He's still down 1-2. A 2-2 the count. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Mustangs have tied the game here in the 6th inning. Jacob Richardson swings and a ground ball down the first baseline. Stutter's got it. He stumbles for a second, steps on the bag, and that will retire the Mustangs in the 6th. But they get a run. On 1 hit, 1 error, they lead 2. After 5.5, St. Joseph and Santa Barbara are tied at 3 as we continue right here. On 6-8, and baseball here on the 6-8 game. The U of St. Joseph and Valley baseball team has tied things up. The Santa Barbara Foresters and St. Joseph have an unearned
leading off the Foresters
in that 6th inning.
Catcher number 33, now Jerry Hearme.
3 runs, 7 hits, 1 error for St. Joseph. 3 runs, 5 hits, 1 error for Santa Barbara. First pitch to Montalbano, skied in the air down the left field line. In foul territory, going over is Maselli, and he will make the catch on foul ground. So Tony Maselli will make the catch in foul territory. The Mustangs, they're at around here in the 6th inning. Nixon Marble now, 5-3. They're starting to get warmed up on the pen. Blake Collins is warming up now for the Mustangs. Dixon's at 82 pitches. I'm guessing they're hoping he can get through the 6th, if not the 7th. If he could have a quick 6th inning, he has not allowed a run since the 3rd. And just 5 hits, he's scattered 5 hits so far in the game. Nixon has battled and he's done a good job. One strikeout, two walks so far today. There's a called strike outside corner. One ball and one strike to count. Mustangs tied with Santa Barbara, defending national champions. And they've won three of the last four NBC World Series. Going away, two balls and a strike. Kyle Neswani is 1-for-2-8. A single up the middle, his first time up. Back in the second, he came in to score the second run of the game. And lined out to center fielder Jacob Richmond to end the third. In the dirt, three balls and a strike now from Dixon Marble. Neswani. They've had at least one base runner in every inning. They have not had a hit, though, since a double from Henderson back in the third of one. Last two base runners have been walks the last two innings. There's a called strike now, full 3-2. Fastball outer half. Mustangs trying to pull off an upset here in the second round of the NBC World Series. There's the 3-2 from Dixon Marble. Fastball tried it again and shot it down the left field line. It's foul out of play. On the season with a 2 today, Dixon has walked 14 now in 58 and one-third innings. The 3-2. Ground ball to short. Schnurbush now bobbles it, and he will make an error. He had a big high hop in his chest with the turf. It got to him quickly, but Jackson Schnurbush, who is a heck of a defensive shortstop, has had a rough game. Three strikeouts and three ABs, and now an error.
Designated hitter number 22, David Greer.
Both shortstops errors here in the sixth. You hope that one doesn't come back to hurt St. Joseph. But another base runner, and it could have been two outs and nobody on base. Second error in the game for St. Joe. That brings up David Greer, the Arizona State Sun Devil, who bats right-handed, who's the DH for the Foresters. One thing that also does is it gets the pitch count even higher for Dixon Marble. Could have been two outs, nobody on him. We could get a quick out right here, and he'd be around 90 pitches. He's at 89 right now, but still just one out and one on. So he's got to throw to first base a couple times like he just did. Greer walked his last time up, and was double off of first base on a catch in the shallow right field area by Jerry Houston. Really off speed that time, swings and misses. Greer was out fourth, trying to ground out to Houston. Back in inning number two for the first out in that frame. No balls and a strike to Greer. Getting 394 this summer for Santa Barbara, which leads the club. He didn't even play in yesterday's game. And they're 9-3 win over San Antonio. 0-1 pitch, ground ball to third, off the glove, right to Jackson Schnurbush, and he one-hops it to first, and now it ricochets off of Ramsey Scott, and that will allow everybody to be safe, and now advancing to third base is Neswani. A hard-hit grounder that goes off the bag of Maselli, or off the glove of Maselli, and then it ricochets to Schnurbush. He had some time, but one-hop it to Scott, and then he couldn't make the play. And now Matt Johnson's going to come out. And it looks like they may go to the bullpen. So the Mustangs struggling defensively here in this inning. We'll see how they score that. If it's a hit and then an error to allow the runner to advance, or if they just give them an error straight up. Looks like they missed, just go error. They've already put the third error up, but nothing in the hit column yet for Santa Barbara. So after Dixon retired the first batter, should have been out number two. Schnurbush boots that one at shortstop. And now an error is going to be on Jackson again, although it was a tough play off the glove of Maselli. The Mustangs not doing themselves any favors here in the sixth. They have tied the game up and now falling apart defensively. And they're not putting a hit up, so they're just going to go straight error. Good throw would have got him, so. Two errors on Jackson Schnurbush in this inning. And Neswani again able to get to third base as he got away. You could probably give him two errors on the player, one on Ramsey Scott, because one allowed him to be safe and then it got away, so he got to third base, and Neswani did. Where the Mustangs could use a ground ball here and get a double play. It's Michael Smith who's 1-for-2, called strike there as they did not go to the pen. Matt Johnson came out, but did not change pitchers. Blake Collins is warming up. Dixon will go to first base. Greer is there. He tried to steal last time, and they got doubled off at first base on the shallow pop-up to right. Both runners on base because of errors, and they did give Sherbush two errors on that play. Or they might have gave, it's got to be Sherbush. So he has three errors in the inning. Wow. They gave an error to allow Greer to reach, and then another error when it got away to allow Nez Lyon to get the third base. Jackson's having a rough game. Now a wild pitch that gets away from Alvarez, and a run will score. The Foresters regain the lead. Boy, Dixon Marble never throws a wild pitch. He does here in the turf, and Frankie couldn't stop it. And both runners move off the bag. It's a 4-3 lead now for Santa Barbara with two errors in the inning. No hits for Santa Barbara since the third. But again, they have regained the lead, 4-3 in the bottom half of the sixth inning. This has been the Bad News Bears for the Mustangs here in the sixth. Goodness. Smith puts it a fastball on the outside corner. Greer in a scoring position. Mustangs not putting their best foot forward here in this game. They've played well offensively against some good pitchers, but boy, defensively, they have not. And you cannot make mistakes against the defending national champions. Two ball and two strike counts. It's a marble up to 94 pitches. Here's the 2-2. Speed is low now. It's full. Three balls and two strikes. Should have been a 1-2-3 inning. Instead, they have a run to take the lead. And they're still just one out with a man in scoring position. Should be a 3-3 game in the top of the seventh right now. Ball fouled off. The way it ricochets around and out of the Santa Barbara dugout down that first base line. And yeah, I feel bad for Jackson because he's had such a heck of a year defensively. He's really good. He's as good as it gets in the mink league at shortstop, but three errors in the inning right now. Dixon twirls towards second base without a throw. 4-3 Santa Barbara, bottom of the sixth inning. Three runs, seven hits, and four errors for St. Joseph. Two earned runs and two unearned runs. Dixon again fakes the throw to second base. Terry Houston broke towards second. Greer, not a huge lead anyway. Four runs, five hits, and one error for Santa Barbara. The pitch, line down the right field line, but foul. This game is enormous for these two teams because the winner will get tomorrow off. Loser will have to even lose his bracket and obviously play many more games to try and get to that top six. The winner puts themselves in a great spot. It's a marble long look into Francisco Alvarez of a 3-2 pitch. He steps off. 4-3 Santa Barbara. Loser of this game, left to bounce back and play tomorrow. Fastball, fly ball, hit well to right center field. Jack Richardson on the run, won't get to it. And one hops the wall. It's going to be a triple at least for Michael Smith. He dives in safely, drives a run as he covers one to right center field. And again, an unearned run as the Forester should have been out 1-2-3 in the inning. They take advantage of it, which the Mustangs have not in this game. Now St. Joseph trails by two runs for the first time in the game. They're down 5-3 here in the bottom.
Second baseman number 11,
that's the John first Bronsima. Hit in this inning. Smith is second hit in the game. Dixon Marble probably trying to get through this last batter because the next batter is a lefty and Blake Holmes is the only Mustang pitcher ready. Again, it has not been Marble's fault here in this inning. Now a deep fly ball hit to left field. Orencio Fisher goes back to the wall, and it is off the wall. It'll be a double from Bronsima. Smith scores easy, obviously. And Now the Mustangs are down by three. 6-3 the score, as now the 100th pitch by Dixon Marble. It goes off the wall and left, and Santa Barbara has doubled up St. Joseph. They've got a free spot here in the sixth inning, and Matt Johnson will make the walk to the pitcher's mound. A triple and a double after what should have been a 1-2-3 inning. Should be 3-3 in the seventh. That's now 6-3 in the bottom half of the sixth inning. Still just one out with a runner at second base. That's it for Dixon Marble. This Bookie Jam is brought to you by St. Joe Frontier Casino. It's the fun place to play because it's St. Joe Frontier Casino. Highland Elliott's 7-9-229 in St. Joseph. For more information, St. Joe Frontier Casino.com. Mustangs baseball from the NBC World Series in Wichita. 6-3 Santa Barbara here at the 6th.
6-8 for 18.
After what should have been a 1-2-3, they've had a triple and a double and back-to-back at-bats. And now Blake Collins will come on for Dixon Marble, trying the last two outs of the sixth. Luffy, that plays in Central Missouri, goes to second base. His teammate there, Jackson Schnurbusch. Back safely is Watson. 6-3 our score, Santa Barbara lead. Dave Ritter back inside Lawrence Dumont Stadium in Wichita. First pitch. Fastball low to Ryan Chandler, who's 0-2 in the game. Collins on the year, boy, he's had a really good year. 4-0 with a 1.64 earned run average. He's made 12 appearances, 5 starts, 7 relief appearances. Fastball outside. He's been a spot starter that has 2 7-inning complete games this year. He got the win in the game that clinched the Maple Leaf North, the win at Chillicothe. Monday the 20th. But now he's behind 3 balls and no strikes. The one thing that's hurt Blake this year is walks, and it has throughout his career. He has 22 walks. He has 32 Ks and 38 and a third, but 22 walks. Blake's pitch is in there for strike one. Pop up down the left field line. It was caught by the third baseman Tony Masella to start the inning. Become an error on Jackson Schnurbusch. Another 2 errors on the next batter by Jackson Schnurbusch. So he missed the high fastball. And then the triple by Smith, the right center field, and the double by Ronsma to left field off the wall. Forsters now with 6 runs and 7 hits. It's a 3-2. High. Came back to get it full, but now he walks it. Honors it first and second for the top of the order now for Santa Barbara. Mustangs have come back tight in the top half of this frame, and again, it should have been a 1-2-3 inning instead. It's a 3-run deficit. Runner at second is still Marble's responsibility. The runner at first base is now Blake Collins. Off speed is outside. Still just one out in the inning. Keep saying it should have been the grip 3-down inning, but there's still only one out. 3 runs are in, 2 are on base. The 1-0 pitch is outside. So 8 pitches thrown by Blake Collins, 6 out of the strike zone. Jerry Houston goes out to talk to Collins, and now Frankie Alvarez will do the same thing. Stangs down 6-3. Shadows now falling over the infield here at Lawrence Dumont Stadium. We're about half of the infield right now. Here's the 2-0 pitch, and there's a called strike at the letters. A fairly high strike zone all game long, but he got the call strike right there. This is John Holland, the shortstop, who is 0-for-3 in the game, struck out for the only strikeout so far. It's the 2-1. It is high and away, 3 balls to strike. But one thing, what a difference, too, that power arms can make. Because the Mustangs have had quite a few strikeouts with runners in scoring position. The Foresters have put the ball in play. There's a foul ball off the left side. 3-2. The Mustangs have struck out in the game 11 times. The Foresters have struck out one time. So they've put the ball in play and it's generated either errors or they've had two ground outs that have generated RBIs. There's a strikeout for Blake Collins. Collins has been a strikeout victim twice. That's the one thing this team really does lack.
Third baseman number nine.
It's a fantastic baseball team. But the one thing they lack is the power arms that can sometimes get you out of jams. Trent Hill is probably the one power arm they have. We've seen it today with the Foresters getting out of jams with just hard heat, so high heat. First pitch, Matt Henderson is 2-for-2 with a double, a triple, and two runs scored is low for ball one. And one thing the Mustangs have done now is they've only struck out three batters in 14 and two-thirds innings here in Wichita. And again, in contrast, they struck out, I think it was seven times yesterday, and now 11 times in this game. Through 15 innings, they struck out 18 times. The called strike, it's 1-1. The called strike, 1-2, to count to Henderson. He's a switching third baseman, batting right-handed now for the first time. He's trying to get the final out. He's had a walk and a strikeout since he's come on in relief. He's had runners at first and second right now. Blake checks second base. Here's the 1-2 pitch to Henderson. Swings and a fly ball to shallow left center field. Richardson comes on, dives and makes the catch. They want to score maybe two runs, at least one, but he saves at least one run on a diving catch in left center field by Jacob Richardson. But the Mustangs give up three runs on two hits. There were three errors and two left on base. Santa Barbara leads St. Joseph after six by a score of 6-3 here at the NBC World Series in Wichita. Back inside Lawrence Dumont Stadium, home of the NBC World Series, the 81st edition of this tournament. The St. Joseph Mustangs now trail the Santa Barbara Foresters by a score of 6-3. As the line is now done for Dixon Marble. He gave up six runs, but only two were earned. So he threw pretty well today. They hit him pretty hard a couple of times, especially the last two batters. But a new pitcher in the game right now for Santa Barbara here to face Trent Hill, Ramsey Scott, and Josh Cassidy as they go 3, 4, and 5. The Mustangs do. At the top of the seventh inning, Mustangs trail 6-3.
Right fielder number 24, Trent
Hill.
Pitcher
is Cody Krause. He's wrapped up this sophomore year at Florida International. He's from Valrico, Florida. And another, how many big right-handers do they have? As Hill has a 1-1 count, swings and misses here. The starter Otto listed 6'4", 225. They bring in McGill, the sophomore from Royal Marymount, 6'7", 230, outside 2-1. And now they bring in Cody Krause, who they listed 6'6", 215. So far this summer, Krause is 2-0 with a 2.65 ERA in 8 relief appearances. Back up the middle, Holland to his left, has it behind second base. He'll throw out Trent Hill by a few steps. So played by Holland, they shaded him up the middle.
First baseman number 32, Ramsey Scott.
For the Forrester shortstop. So McGill now in line for the win, although he gave up the tying run. Santa Barbara has never trailed in the game, and the Mustangs have had numerous chances to take the lead. Which is mowed away for ball one to Ramsey Scott. Ramsey's due, he's 0-3. Struck out his last time up. Ramsey was out on two ground balls, one to second, one to third, and the second, third innings, respectively. There's a call strike. Count is 1-1. One out here in the top of the seventh inning. St. Joseph trailing Santa Barbara 6-3. Krause's pitch and a ground ball, a two-hopper right at the head of Holland the shortstop. It's a nice high hop on this bouncy turf at Lawrence Dumont Stadium. Throws out Ramsey Scott, so 2 up, 2 down as Hill and Scott retired On ground balls to shortstop John Holland. That'll bring up Josh Cassidy.
Designated hitter number 17, Josh Cassidy.
Cassidy 2-for-3, struck out looking his last time up to close out the fifth inning. Single and scored back in the fourth inning, and double and scored back in the second. He has 2 of the 3 Mustang runs in the game. Looks at ball one inside from Cody Krause. Krause's pitch is hit well to center field. Going back is Chandler on the run to the warning track. Won't get there. And one hops the wall, hits the batter's eye. And he's still going to run, and they will call it a ground rule double. So it hit the batter's eye beyond the outfield fence and ricocheted back into fair territory. So it will be a ground rule double for Josh Cassidy. He's having a technical tournament. He's 3-for-4 in this game, now 4-for-8. A two-out double. Let's see if they can get a run back as Tony Maselli will come in. Cassidy now 3-for-4. He has 3 of their 8 base hits. Now it's Tony Maselli, who's due. He's 0-for-2. Struck out his last time up. Walked in the fourth, was stranded. And then struck out in the second. Ricky Alvarez on deck, but there are 2 outs. Now a chopper, a high chopper back behind the mound. Going to be a tough play, and no throw. Bronson will fake the throw to see if he can get Cassidy off of third base. He could not. So an infield single and a high chopper they got just beyond the pitcher's mound. Second baseman for the Foresters grabbed him to fake the throw. A pretty smart play to see if he could get Cassidy off of third base. He did not. And now it's up to Francisco Alvarez.
Catcher number 20, Francisco Alvarez.
Infield single for Tony Maselli. 2 on, 2 out. Frankie hit a double. A ground rule over the left. Back in the second for the first run of the game. He is 2-for-3. Had a triple on the right field line his last time up, so he's got a double and triple in the game. Let's see if he can come through with 2 down here against Cody Krause. Maselli does not go. Fastball right down the middle. For the Mustangs, it seems like they've had base runners at least 2 almost every inning. It's not been quite that many, but nearly. Every inning but 2. So in 5 of their 7 innings, they've had at least 2 base runners. And just 3 runs to show for it. Alvarez swings and misses a high fastball. Now he's down 0-2. After 2 2-out base hits for the Mustangs, it's up to Francisco Alvarez as they trail by 3 here in the 7th inning. See if Frankie can come through here. Montalbano will set up outside. Let's see if they bring some off-speed stuff outside. It's a fastball no other way, and he fouls it off. Mustangs need a run right here. In these situations, they have not been good in this game. Were very good yesterday, getting all 8 runs scored with 2 outs. A lot of runners on base so far in this contest. No balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs, 2-1. Let's see if Maselli goes here. He doesn't. Fastball, I don't think it might have been a slider. It was off the end of the bat, foul off the right side. Frankie staying alive. He was down 0-2, 2 consecutive foul balls. Jerry Houston hopes to get a chance as he waits on deck. Cassidy a 2-out double. An infield single by Maselli. First and third, 2 down. 6-3 Santa Barbara. Krause's pitch. Fastball got him, swing and miss, and that's going to retire to the side. Mustangs lead 2 on base again. Stretch time here in Wichita after 6.5. It's Santa Barbara 6 and St. Joseph 3.
All right,
here at the NBC World Series.
Time to stand up and stretch, though, ladies and gentlemen. NBC Hall of Famer.
Mustangs can't rally in this one. They're going to kick themselves as they have left 11 men on base through their 7 at-bats so far in the game. They are down by a score of 6-3 as Blake Collins stays on here in the 7th inning to try and keep this a 3-run deficit. Now, Granger Stutter will line one down the left field line.
First baseman number 7, Granger Stutter.
Foul ball. Blake Collins. Final 2 outs in that 6th inning. 3 unearned runs, though, gave Santa Barbara the lead. No balls and a strike. Good shot. 1 ball, 1 strike to count now from Cole to Granger Stoddard, who was 0 for 3 in the game. Stoddard again plays at Texas State. He was 1 for 3 yesterday in their win over San Antonio. 1-1. They call a strike inside the floor. One ball, two strikes to count. We got a 331 average, 4 homers, 40 RBIs this summer. 281 hitter at Texas State. 11 home runs, 41 RBI. 1-2, fouled away. Let's see if Chucky can redeem himself. The Texas State.
He's got no clue.
The Bobcats. That's not quite as cool as Anteaters.
I was going to say Armadillos.
Here's the 1-2 from Blake Collins and a ground ball toward Jerry Houston. He short hops it and he will boot it as well. So the Mustang defense continues to be abysmal in this game. That'll be error number 5 on St. Joseph. Now that was a tougher play. He had to angle towards second base. He tried to short hop it, but nonetheless, an error on St. Joseph.
Jeremy Maltavon.
We'd have to check every game this year, but I wouldn't be surprised if that is a season high against the defending national champions. You just can't do it. I don't want to say they've outplayed Santa Barbara, but they certainly could have the lead if you take away all the errors and miscues. Now Montalbano sends him to left field. Over is Horencio Fisher. He'll run it down in the gap in the alley in left center as Montalbano is now 0 for 4 in the game.
Left fielder number 4, Tyler Nesloni.
He just can't make 5 errors against a team of this quality. Team, for the most part, they're a pretty good defensive team all year long. For the most part, they've had their issues at times. 5 in the NBC World Series, too much. On any game, here's a line drive to right center field that's going to find the alley. All the way to the wall, and it will stay in the park. It almost popped up over the wall. It's going to score. Stuttered all the way from third base. He's going to try for 3, slides in, and he will get there safely. Tyler Nesloni, a triple to right center field, and Santa Barbara takes a 7-3 lead on another unearned run in the game, their 5th off of Mustang pitcher. That ball was clobbered to right
center. Designated hitter, number 22, David Greer.
Now it's a 7-3 game. Santa Barbara extends its lead. Mustangs falling apart here in the late innings. Boy, they held it together for so long early in the game with Santa Barbara having a lot of opportunities early on to really kind of blow open the game. They didn't. And now out comes Matt Johnson. They may go to the pen to bring in John Milan, the right-hander, against the righty David Greer. Matt Johnson makes a slow walk out to the mound. And for Santa Barbara now, they have 2 triples. They have 3 doubles in the game. So the Mustangs have out-hit Santa Barbara, but 5 of their 8 hits have gone for extra bases. So the Mustangs have pretty much been all singles, except for Josh Caskey's double. So they've had to go station to station and try and get consecutive hits while Santa Barbara's been able to get extra base hits to not get runs or get into scoring position. And now they will go to the bullpen. As a pitching change is brought to you by St. Joe Frontier Casino. It's the fun place to play. Visit St. Joe Frontier Casino, Highland Avenue, the 7th, St. Joseph. For more information, visit stjoefrontiercasino.com. This is Mustangs Baseball on 680K. It is the Morris DuPont Stadium. Thanks for joining me for Mustangs Baseball tonight. St. Joe Summer College Baseball Team trailing, though, in this contest. They trail the Santa Barbara Force with a box score of 73 now. We are in the bottom of the 7th inning. And they've got enough of themselves, unfortunately. John Milan, the new pitcher. John, fairly new to the Mustangs. He will pitch for the first time here at the NBC World Series. He's made just 2 appearances. The regular season got picked up late.
Designated hitter number 22.
No decisions, a 3.38 earned run average. John's first pitch is right down low for a fastball for strike 1. David Greer, the DH, hits in the 6th hole. He's 0-2 in the game. He reached on an error. That was the 2 errors by Jackson Schnurbusch last inning. third out in the inning. Said he came to score a run, which is outside, 1-1. John Milan has signed to play at Cameron University, a Division II school in Oklahoma. He spent 2 years at Western Texas College. He was 4-5 this past year, 15 appearances, 12 starts now, so he missed here. His ERA this past year was at 8.80. Case since he's been with the Mustangs. He has 3 strikeouts, 1 walk, 5 hits though, in 2 2/3 innings. Maryland's pitch in the dirt, 2-2 to him. David Greer from Scottsdale, Arizona. Plays at Arizona State. He just died down a little bit here at Lawrence Dumont, still blowing a tad, not a whole lot. Ground ball to third base. Maselli will go to third base. Didn't have time to go home on a high chopper. Thought about it, couldn't do it. Now it's an 8-3 Santa Barbara lead on the third
number three,
round out RBI. And that kind of goes back to my point of power pitching. We could use a strikeout in that situation. The Mustang pitching staff only struck out 3 batters in the 2 games they've played so far. And the Forrester pitching staff have been able to get some key strikeouts. And sometimes you just get the ball in play, you can score a run. They've done 3 times now with that runner at third base on less than 2 outs. Neslani scores after his triple, the RBI for Greer, his first in the game. 1-1 now to Michael Smith. He had the triple last inning after the 2 errors. 2-3 in the game. Outside on a slider, John Milan, 2 balls and a strike. Smith flew out to left fielder Orencio Fisher back in the fourth. He had a double in the second. He has a triple and a double. There are 3 players in this game that have triples and doubles, at least one of each. One Mustang, that's Frankie Alvarez. Chopper throws third on a high hop. It is Tony Maselli. He'll grab it, throw to first base, and that will do it for Santa Barbara in the seventh. But in the inning, they get 2 runs on 1 hit. There was 1 error. They did not make it back. We're through 7. St. Joseph trails Santa Barbara 8-3 right here on 680.
Second baseman number 14, Jerry Houston.
Cody Kraus staying out for his second inning of work for Santa Barbara. Faced Jerry Houston to start this 8th inning of play. It's an 8-3 lead for Santa Barbara. Dave Ritter back inside Lawrence Dumont Stadium. It's a 3-ball count to Jerry Houston to start this 8th inning. St. Joseph needs to start the rally right now. Houston 1-for-1 with 2 walks in the game. He's been on base all 3 times, has 2 stolen bases today. And that looks at a strike on the inner half. 3 balls and a strike from Cody Kraus to Jerry Houston. Mustangs tied the game up in the 6th at 3, and then they gave up 3 unearned in the 6th, and then 2 more in the 7th ground ball. The short Holland right there, he'll throw out Houston as he's retired for the first time in the game. 1-1 down.
Shortstop number 3, Jackson Sherman.
Jackson's had a rough day. 0-for-3 with 3 strikeouts, and 2 of the strikeouts have come up with a runner at third base. Game with runners at second. There's a cold strike outside. And then he unfortunately made the 3 errors in that 3-run 6th inning. The 0-1, my fastball swung on and fouled it back to the screen. He's down 0-2 with 1 out, nobody on base. Top of the order is on deck. Mustangs down 5. 8-3 is the score. They have out-hit Santa Barbara 9-8, but they've been outscored 8-3, and they have out-erred the Foresters 5-1. That's the big stat. Well, the big stats, the score. To get to 8-3, 5-1 is a pretty major number. The ball and 2 strikes now to Jackson. Fly ball down the right field line, twisting, going to stay in the fair territory, just barely, and it's going to be caught by Michael Smith. The first time he doesn't strike out.
Let's go to number 44, Orencio Fisher.
2 up, 2 down. Now they tried a 2-out rally last inning. And a double from Cassian, a single from Maselli, but Alvarez struck out. See if Florencio can start something. He's 1-for-4 in the game. He was the one at the plate when they tied the game, as he reached on an error by the shortstop Holland, the only error in the game for Santa Barbara. And now a fly ball hit deep down the left field line, chasing this Neslani, and he can't get there. It's going to one hop and go against the wall. Lorenzo around second base and stay right there. A double on the left field line for Lorenzo Fisher. So just like last inning, he gets a two-out fielder number four,
Jacob Richardson.
Second hit in the game, fourth in the NBC World Series for Lorenzo Fisher. Now, we'll see if Jacob Richardson can come through. He's 1-for-4, a loop single back in the first inning. Since that point in time, he's struck out twice and grounded out to first. By the way, they have a new first baseman, the Foresters do. Granger Studdard has been lifted for Troy Conyers. Conyers plays at the University of San Diego. He's from Lakeside, California, 277 hitter. Foul ball off the bat of Richardson. The 0-1. Kraus checks second base. Delivers home, one away. One ball and one strike to count. Mustangs down 5. They need base runners. They've got one on right now. Again, they have multi hits from 3 different Mustangs. They have 10 hits in the game, but just 3 runs to show for it. They've left 11 on base. There's a 12th out there right now. Ground ball up the middle. It's a chopper. It could be tough. Holland barehands it. Throws to first base. What a play by John Holland to retire the Mustang. Down left. 12 on base. We're through 7.5. We're in the bottom half of the 8th inning. Santa Barbara leads St. Joseph 8-3 from the NBC World Series here in Wichita, Kansas. Bottom half of the 8th inning, as we'll see Steve D'Amico. The first time here at the NBC World Series, the Mustang closer. Here, Mustangs now. It's on the season, Steve, 1-1 with a 2.45 ERA at 14 2/3 innings. 15 appearances, does have 5 saves, just 1 blown save. Came on that Saturday against Joplin. He's bounced back in a couple of innings. 6 that point in time.
John Bryce.
8-9-1 for Santa Barbara. They'll try and extend their 5-0 lead, or 5-run lead, I should say. It's an 8-3 score. Getting jammed this time is Bronsma, and he will go down the right field line and foul it off. Steve D'Amico on. Here's the 4th pitcher of the game for the Mustangs. D'Amico has struck out 21 and walked 7 in 14 2/3 innings. He's allowed only 10 hits this year in 14 2/3 as a pitch out. 1 ball, 1 strike to count to Bronsma. It's 2-for-3 in the game. He had a double in that 3 unearned run 6th inning. Here's a foul ball off the right side, going to get out of play. But all of the Hayesville Aviators that are right there, they all kind of scattered like roaches when the lights come on. They were kind of scared to catch the ball. Not sure they saw it ever. 0-2 the count. Make it 1-2 the count. And now a liner to right field for a base hit. Great piece of hitting by Bronsma. He just lunged out on a off-speed pitch, low and away, went and got it and just poked it to right field. That was a good at bat. So he's down 1-2 and got the base hit. So single to right field. That one right
now. Pinch hitting.
A pinch hitter
for Santa Barbara.
Robbie Masur, Mason. And Robbie's the guy that will make his first, this will be his first at-bat for the Foresters. He is not on their roster on their website. He is on
the number 12, Robbie Masur.
He is on the roster for the NBC, but they just picked him up for the NBC World Series. Getting a pinch hit now, and he swings and misses. Now it's a 1-1 count. Robbie Masur hits. He bats right-handed. Square first base and nobody out. Big goes pitching high and deep to left field. Orencio back to the fence, and it is gone. His first at-bat this season for Santa Barbara. And Robbie Masser hits a home run to left field to make it a 10-3 game. Again, they just picked him up. Not even on the roster that they give us for the media.
Shortstop number 13, John Holland.
On the website roster, that's the only reason I knew who it was. But I know nothing else about Robbie Masser except he's one for one with a two-run home run as now D'Amico throws behind John Holland. And now Holland walks toward D'Amico. So after a home run, D'Amico threw behind Holland. Intentional or not, Holland didn't like it. And now he's talking to the Mustang bench. Here we go at the NBC World Series. Tries to throw at him again. Now the Foresters are coming out of their dugout. So he has thrown behind him twice. The Foresters coming out of the dugout. This is probably unnecessary. But unfortunately, we have seen some unnecessary things happen at the NBC World Series in years prior to this one. The bullpen was on their way down from the pen. The dugout was out. Now Matt Johnson's going to come out and talk to Steve D'Amico and his team. So cooler heads are going to prevail because of Matt Johnson. D'Amico gives up the home run and tries to just, I don't know if he tried to hit it, but he threw behind it twice. No matter if you're trying or not, that looks bad when that happens, especially after a home run. Matt Johnson, bring his team together, and again, do not want something stupid to happen like it has in the past. Here's D'Amico's pitch. It's in the dirt. Now 3-0, and Holland just stares at him. Right down the middle. Bullpen is still standing up and ready. And honestly, I've never really understood why you would throw at the next guy after a different guy hit a home run. Strike him, strike this guy out. He doesn't. Line drive to center field. They sit. And Holland barks at him the whole way down and stares him down after he rounds first base. Ramsey Scott gets right in his mug now.
Third baseman number 9, Matt Henderson.
No need for some of the stuff that's going on now. Holland at first base. That's his first hit in the game, so he's only been able to get a hit off of Steve D'Amico. The Mustangs have struck out two batters in the game, and they've both been Holland, who's at first base. Next pitch outside of the strike zone for ball one from Steve D'Amico. Matt Henderson got things going early in the game. As he tripled in the opening frame and then scored and then doubled. Off the hand of D'Amico, Schnurbusch has it close to first base in time. That'll be a 1-6-3 ground out off the bare hand of D'Amico. He says he's fine. Alvarez goes out to check. That might have been a base hit had it not gone off.
First baseman number 44, Troy Conyers.
It'll be a 1-6-3 ground out. After Matt Johnson went out to talk to his entire infield and Steve D'Amico, he's throwing strikes from there on out. And that'll be Troy Conyers batting for the first time. He's the first baseman now. Big left-hander. plays at San Diego. They list him at 6'5", 230. Some big dudes on this team. I don't know if I want to bench clearing for all for the Mustangs. Actually, I know I don't, but I like the chances for Sanchez. Here's a 1-0 from DeVico. Smith. High heat that time to Conyers. They scored two in the inning of a two-run home run by Robbie Masson. His first ever at-bat for the Santa Barbara Foresters. It's fallen apart here in these last three innings for St. Joseph. Outside, Tuna. Mustangs tied the game at three in the top of inning number six, and then gave it three under and then six, two more in the seventh, and two more here in the eighth. Pitch home. Ooh, just missed inside. Now 3-1 to count to Conyers. He was 0-3 yesterday with a strikeout and two walks. He's 277 this season with two homers and seven RBI. Just mowing in and walking. Now, I'll bring up their big stick, Jeremy Montalbano, who's 0-4.
Catching number 33, Jeremy Montalbano.
Montalbano flew out to left, flew out to third base in foul territory to ground out to short and a pop up in the foul territory to Frankie Alvarez, the catcher for the Mustangs. First pitch, slider swung in. DeVico gave up the two-run home run, gave up the single to Holland after he threw behind him twice. I guess Holland should be grateful he didn't get hit by a 90 plus mile an hour fastball. All outside makes it 1-1. Two on, one out. Let's make it, yeah, just one out. Outside. And career score here in the eighth inning. Santa Barbara, heck, if they get one more run here, it'll be a run rule game. Second consecutive year. So they could end the game with a base hit. It's obviously just get one more AB anyway, but base hit could end the game. Now 3-1. Nico checks second base where Holland, his good friend, is, and he brings it home now, fouled away. Nico's at a 24-pitch inning, has retired one batter so far. The Liberal BJs and the Hayesville Aviators are each waiting. This game, their game is supposed to start at 7. And now it's a pitch outside on the wall. Steve DeVico not having a lot of success.
Number 40,
two runs over four,
Tyler Neslami.
Two singles allowed, and now two walks allowed. Tyler Neslami, last time up, tripled and scored in their two-run seventh inning. He drove in a run as well. Neslami looks at a fastball high. Base is loaded. Heck, a walk here. Making a walk-off win here in the eighth inning. Did not think it was going to get to this. There's Lonnie a big swing and he foul tipped right in the glove of Francisco Alvarez. It was a 3-3 game after the top of the sixth inning. Mustangs had a chance to take the lead. And then three errors. Three runs the next half inning. There's a call strike, 1-2 to Neslani. Neslani plays his college baseball at Texas Tech at 286, six homers, 35 RBI, and 55 starts for the Red Raiders this past season in the Big 12. On the ground, they'll go home with it, and they get the force out as Holland slides into Francisco Alvarez very hard. Frankie takes it like a man, doesn't do anything about it. He could have said something to Holland, who again was the guy they threw behind. He slid in hard to home and A few Mustangs stuck out of the dugout. Frankie's
Posey. Here, number 22, David Greer.
Again, we've seen things like that happen in Buster Posey type play. He's at home. That was a very aggressive slide past home plate. They got the out at home to continue the game, or else that would have been it. Pitch is outside. Base is still loaded. Two outs now. DeNico trying to work out of this to keep the game alive and have one more at bat for the Mustangs. There's a call strike. Now a 30-pitch inning for Steve DeNico. Here's the pitch in the dirt again. 2-1 the count. Steve had just a fantastic season going, and then unfortunately had a rough inning against Joplin. Final Saturday of the regular season. Blew the save. Fastball and swings and missed up. Greer does. Bounced back with two decent performances, but has struggled here at the NBC. His final numbers are not going to look as good as what they were at one point in time. The 2-2, low and away, and now it's full. Bases loaded, full count. Santa Barbara, one run away from a run rule game here in Wichita. Santa Barbara 10, St. Joseph 3, right here on 680 KFU.
Also, your guys are Santa Barbara number 5, Ryan Walker.
Since they will have 3, 4, and 5 due up, Trent Hill, Ramsey Scott, and Francisco Alvarez, and they will face a new pitcher. Let's see who they're putting in the game.
Leading off the Mustangs, outfielder number 24, Trent Hill.
Trent Hill hitting. Good off spot here in the ninth inning for St. Joseph. It's a 10-3 lead. And now a bouncing ball up the middle. Holland to his left has it, and he bobbles it. And likely an infield hit for Trent Hill. It was going to be a tough play. The new pitcher is Elliot Saray.
First base for number 32, Ramsey Scott.
Irvine. He's not an anteater. I believe they'll give him a hit. Holland had come a long way and had it. I'm not sure if he got it. There it is. It's a base hit. I don't know if they've been doing that the entire game, but I guess I need to just hold up. Single. So that is a single. Well, that'll be an infield hit for Trent Hill. He's now 1-for-3 in the game and 5-of-8 here at the NBC World Series. Saray brings it home and a fastball after a ball one is going to be a swing on this by Ramsey Scott. Ramsey's 0-for-4 in the game. Just 1-for-8 here in Wichita in the first two games. Josh Cassidy is on deck. Hill, not a big lead. Saray, a left-hander. Now an off-speed pitch, but Ramsey swings and misses out. In the dirt. The Foresters are three outs away from advancing. As the defending champions look to move to 2-0. Mustangs will move, and they'll play tomorrow at a time to be announced. We'll carry the game whenever it is, but find out at some point in time. Now a swing and a miss. It gets behind Montalbano. Ramsey Scott cannot advance. Hill can to second base, but it is a strikeout for the first out here.
Designated hitter number 17, Josh Cassidy.
It's 1-for-9 now here in Wichita, 0-for-5 today. And they may go to a new pitcher just to get some guys some work. They'll have tomorrow off unless the Mustangs can rally. And Joel will have to come back. Been decided already that they'll go with Miles Gulley tomorrow, the Mustangs, if they do play tomorrow. No matter what they play, game three will be Miles Gulley's game. Meeting at the mound right now here in a 7-run game in the top of the ninth inning with one out. Ryan Hill is at second base with one down for Josh Cass, who's had himself a game. He's 3-for-4 in that DH spot. They keep Saray in the game. Elliott Surratt, UC Irvine this past year was a starter, made 15 starts, he was 6-6 at 4.02 ERA. Pitched 103 innings. That's a lot in college baseball. 115 hits, but he also struck out 88 and walked 18. Their team was 33-23 and 15-9 in the Big West at UC Irvine. First pitch to he throws to Josh Cassie, a fastball for his back on the outside. Cassie, 3 out of 4. Mustangs do have 10 hits in the game. 5 errors in the game. Santa Barbara has 11 hits. Actually, Mustangs have 11 hits after that infield single by Trent Hill. Both teams with 11 hits, but a 10-3 lead. Another fastball, same spot, same result. Called strike number 2. The ball's 2 strikes with 1 out. Josh Cassidy looks at one in the dirt. Now it's 1-2. On deck is Tony Maselli. But they might bring in Jordan Powell or somebody like that to hit for Maselli against the left-hander. But we're going to see Jordan tomorrow. I'm pretty sure we'll see Max Ayub, the catcher, back up to Frankie Alvarez. And now a swing miss, struck him out. Josh Cassidy strikes out. He finishes 3-for-5 in the game.
Third baseman number 34, Tony Maselli.
Is something that, just when you look at the numbers for Santa Barbara, they average almost 9 strikeouts per game. The Mustangs just, they haven't struck anybody out in this tournament. They've struck out now 4 batters in 17
games. Fans, this time we can have all participants for baseball around the clock.
Struck Gina out 14 times in this game,
make
and
your way to the
21
times in
17 and 2/3 innings.
Which is outside after a goal. Baseball around the clock, there's plays that work to the first base side gate over by the sweet spot.
The one thing this team doesn't have, what the Minkley doesn't have besides Sam Perez. It's the one more. All strike in her hand. Mustang down to their final strike now. Maselli 1-for-3 in the game with an infield single his last time up. Tony now 3-for-8 here at the NBC. Stays alive, fouls it back behind home plate. Santa Barbara has scored 10 runs, but only 4 have been earned. The Mustangs should have more than just 3 runs in the game, but haven't. Take advantage of opportunities. All strike 3, and that will do it. St. Joseph Mustangs lose today to Santa Barbara. 4
scores
by
Barbara. Score.
Santa Barbara 3.
Now
1-1 here in Wichita. We'll play tomorrow in the losing
bracket. St. Joe, Missouri Mustangs
16 on the season.
3.
And back with postgame as we continue. St. Joseph Mustangs
lose. Take advantage of this time if we can have all the remaining.
St. Joseph Mustangs lose to the Santa Barbara Foresters. Our final score 10-3, and again, it fell apart late for St. Joseph. They tied the game at 3 in the top of inning number 6, and then all of a sudden, 3 errors in the bottom half inning allowed 3 unearned runs to score. They gave up 2 more unearned runs in the 7th inning, and then gave up a 2-run shot in the 8th. And that was all she wrote. Mustangs lose 10-3 after 7 unearned runs by Santa Barbara here in this game today. St. Joseph and played well early on, battled their tails off, and had a chance. Fell apart with their defense there late in the game. St. Joseph, 3 runs, 11 hits, and 5 errors in the contest. They left 13 men on base. Santa Barbara, 10 runs, 11 hits, and 1 error. They left 8 men on
base. And the official start time between Liberal.
Lewis Dixon Marble, he threw well though.
There will be 9-0-5.
7 hits, 6 runs.
9-0-5. Official start time.
He struck out 1, walked 2. Blake Collins threw 1 inning. He gave up 1 hit, 2 runs. They were unearned as well. Jerry Heaton had an error in that next inning. He struck out 1, walked 1. John Malone went an inning. He went 2/3 of an inning. Did not give up a base runner. He had 2 perfect outs. Perfect appearance with the 2 outs that he got. And then Steve D'Amico came on in a wild 8th inning. He threw 1 inning, gave up 3 hits, 2 runs. Both were earned. He struck out 1, walked 2, but gave up a 2-run home run. And that's 8th inning. The win goes to Tyler McGill. He went inning and 2/3 of relief, gave up a hit, a run, and was unearned, struck out 4, walked 1. The starter. Glenn Otto goes 4-1/3, gave up 6 hits, 2 runs. Both were earned. He struck out 4, walked. Megan struck out 7, walked 4. Cody Krause goes 2 innings. He gave up 3 hits, no runs. Struck out 1, didn't walk the batter. And then Elliot Saray came in. He struck out the side in the ninth inning, but then he got 1 base hit in the contest. Mustang.
Fans, don't forget Lawrence Newmont Stadium is a good
place. They did 11 hits in the contest.
They hit the ball
well. Honestly, they were fine.
If you would like to please do so on the main conference level, we're in the Hard Block Cafe. Thank you for your cooperation.
27 outs.
Fans, please don't forget the clock above the right field
strikeouts tonight.
The clock is unique for the ABC World Series and for 5 game time.
Jake Gondegrad goes 1-for-5.
The clock operates from the first pitch of the game until the end of the ninth inning. 90 seconds are allowed between innings. 90 seconds
twice in the game.
The ball results when the pitcher does not deliver the ball within 20 seconds when he is responsible for the delay.
Four guys
results on the batter's in a buffer and to take the pitch with 5 seconds or more seconds showing the clock on the buzzer set.
Double, triple,
there is a time of delay, no pitch results. However, if the ball has been batted on the catcher, the horn is ignored.
Triple, two release. One run scored.
Tonight's 50-50 raffle presented by Farm Bureau Insurance agent Scott Klein benefits the Kansas Humane Society.
Breaking continues.
Tonight's proceeds go to one lucky fan who purchases a raffle ticket.
The winner
is announced during the eighth inning of tonight's game. To support tonight's raffle, we'll find a representative from the Kansas Humane Society. Raffle tickets are 2 for $2, 6 for $5, 15 for $10, and 40 for $20.
I was just going over some of the numbers there. They get one thing, their team get way too much on the strikeout, 15 strikeouts. And boy, a lot of early ones with guys in scoring position too, and that hurt you.
It was. It came out of our approach. I think we chased a high pitch game on the ones we had. Usually, we're going to catch up the issue. I don't know if the end of the game got to them.
White Street is the official live staff provider of the National Baseball Conference. Follow our team on the ABC Baseball website. Follow all
the rules. Battled the first 3 innings. He gave up 3 runs. He got hung in there.
Then you come back right from the palm of your hand.
3-3.
National Baseball Conference.
He had a half segment. He had a chance to take the lead. Couldn't do it. But then, boy, 3 errors. And boy, I feel for Jackson. He's a great defensive shortstop. He made 3 errors in the inning himself and led to 300 runs. And all of a sudden, it kind of fell apart.
I mean, those things happen. He's been solid.
Fans, would you please direct your attention to the field? Now entering from the first base side gate are the remaining 150 participants of Baseball Around the Clock, presented by Coleman and KWCH Channel 12. These fans have endured 17 games and 56 hours of baseball and are just 2 games away from surviving Baseball Around the Clock. Baseball Around the Clock begins Friday evening with nearly 200 contestants. 2015 marks the 26th anniversary of Baseball Around the Clock, and it's been one of the best weekends in nearly a decade. Upon completion of the final check-in during tonight's 10 o'clock game, these individuals will receive tickets to the remainder of the 81st NBC World Series, a t-shirt showing their achievements, the opportunity to win numerous prizes throughout tonight's feature game, and one lucky survivor will win $500 cash prize.
Yeah, that's the frustrating
thing. Our first ever fans, please keep put your hands together and give the participants of the Nicole Curtis 26th Annual Baseball Around the Clock a round.
You just kind of settle your team down and say, no more of this?
I just only like get one chance. You're going to throw it twice. So we're going to go inside and we're going to have that celebration.
Was there a celebration? I guess I didn't see.
Yeah, there was a big celebration.
Diamond is the official baseball of the National Baseball Congress and the NBC World Series. The Diamond NBC Jet Baseball is being used for all NBC World Series games this summer. You too can use the Diamond NBC Jet by purchasing them at Baseball Savings.
We're going to go inside at that point. And the story is good. He has one opportunity not to, but
Yeah, I even see that.
Fair weather season is here. They compare to Kansas stores, whatever you are in, wherever you are, with the store keeps all the weather out. Your phone or mobile device.
Throw inside.
Interactive radar.
Yeah, the two is probably
live weather reports. Download the free StormKeep World Weather app today.
It's not where you keep throwing drones.
It's where today's players got their start. Everyday high school athletes try to do their best.
It's a matter of bouncing back.
And last year, you kind of struggled to do that. Catch at Kansas.com. Follow your teams at Catch at Kansas.com. Kansas' number one source for high school sports. Baseball fans, listen up. There's only one store that can deliver the goods when it comes to everything baseball. Find the best gear, the lowest prices, a friendly staff, and best deals that never stop. All at BaseballSavings.com, your official team supplier of the NBC World Series. Check them out online.
Do you
stop
feel
by
like
retail
the leadership, it seems like it to me, like the leadership is just so much stronger on this team, especially with the team you have here. Because in years past, as we've talked about,
attention NBC baseball fans, connect with the outdoors this summer with Coleman. Enjoy 25% off through August at the local Coleman Factory Outlet store, including on their new fast pitch tents. See the Coleman ad in your program for details.
And I have a couple guys on the team right now that I think they feel no matter what we lost, everybody's going to lose one eventually. Just a matter of we got this one out of the way, all theirs, and we swept out a bunch of times on the plate, and we get back on board and they're happy to go.
Good to see Josh Cassidy. He swung out really well today. 3-for-5, had a couple of doubles in the game. And good for Frankie, too. He's been struggling a little bit. He gets a couple of big hits for you to get a double and triple. And again, I'm not sure he was going to make it to third base, but luckily they didn't get the cutoff guy. But good to see those two guys, who at times have been good, but then at times they've struggled, kind of start to get something going here.
Yeah, it's nice to see both of them. I mean, Frankie's done a great job for us all the defense. He was hot for doing the offense. He kind of had a lot of it's nice to see him get some big hits in big situations like Cassidy's.
She's starting really swing well.
He's a professional hitter. The last few times, I think when we moved him down to that 5-4, I think he's going to be a professional hitter.
Have they said anything about a time for tomorrow?
I was told 5:30. So 5:30 in the hour is 3 games going.
5:30 tomorrow, I think it's a Lake Erie. Okay. I think they won today, so I think that's really important. All right, let's go get them tomorrow. We'll see you then. Matt Johnson mentioned the Mustangs. Again, they fall by a final score 10-3 to Santa Barbara, as their record now is at 36-16, 1-1 here at the NBC World Series. Santa Barbara is now 37-7. Mustangs are stuck in the losing bracket, and they will play at 5:30, as we just heard from Coach Johnson. And we will... Those are options tomorrow. We'll put it on 6:80 tomorrow. We'll put it on 6:80 tomorrow night, 5:30, the easy start time. And I believe that is the first game of the night since it's just 3 games. So hopefully it won't be an hour and a half, even if it was today. But there's still a 10 o'clock game after the 7 o'clock game that's warming up right now. The 7 o'clock game is supposed to go at 9:05. So 2 hours and 5 minutes late, that means they are set for a 12:05 start for the 10 o'clock game, and the Mustangs are originally supposed to play in that game. Thank goodness they did not. But in the final score, Mustangs fall to Santa Barbara 10-3. That'll wrap things up. Thanks to Jim Black for coming down, putting it all on the internet. This was on St. Joseph Post all night long, too. And again, they'll play tomorrow at 5:30. We'll have a game for you right here on 680 KFDQ. Hey there, everybody. I'm Dave Rigger. So long from Lawrence Dumont Stadium here in Wichita.
Red meat.
Was it meat?
No, none of them are you.
Because I wasn't moving on the post.
You weren't?
I don't know. 1 year.
But it's still shouldn't. It's all on this.
I think people turned it off a long time ago. Those are the kind of ones you don't want to watch.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight we have our fourth member of the 2015 NBC Hall of Fame class to be inducted. John Braden, a pillar of baseball history in Fort Wayne, Indiana, made a major impact.